The 16th plans to further connect with Christian youth by giving up on Catholicism. Quote, in order to really relate to modern teens, he needs to make religion a much smaller part of his busy life, just like they do. And it's already working. Tweets like, can someone go to church for me, LOL, hashtag sleeping in, have been retweeted over a million times by lazy Catholic teens, while tweets like, if God was real, how come there's so much murder, and I'm still Catholic, I just don't go to church or believe in Jesus, have been especially successful with college students who are questioning the church's teaching.
It's really cool to see that the Pope is as active on social media and as skeptical about God as I am. Look, he just tweeted, I'm not religious, I'm spiritual. That's totally how I feel.
Pope Benedict's aides say his next project involves reaching out to Muslims by sitting down with Islamic leaders and proclaiming his undying allegiance to Allah.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You are invited here to take control of the airwaves and bring up whatever is on your mind. The number, it's toll-free, and it's brought to you by ProXPN. It's 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Well, I teased the story last night about Barack Obama and this supposed plan to destroy the Islamic State. We'll get into that here in a moment, but there's an indicator, and by the way, joining you in the studio this evening, it's Ian here.
And Johnson.
And Mark.
There's an indicator that we've got the right thing to talk about when the individuals on the show bring in the same show prep without having consulted one another prior to the show, because normally we consult right before we start the show. Mark, you have brought in the story, as did I, and it's pretty outrageous. From Everett, Pennsylvania, the freethoughtproject.com reporting. These guys get some really great stories.
They do.
An amazing job. At Everett, Pennsylvania, a teenager is facing 2 years locked away over some offensive photos posted to his Facebook account. The photos depict him in mock sexual positions with a Jesus statue, and the Jesus statue does not appear to have been harmed during the incident. KRON Channel 4 reports the photos were taken and uploaded in July in front of the Love of the Name of Christ Christian organization in his hometown of Everett, Pennsylvania. The young man has been charged with desecration of a venerated object.
Well, it certainly sounds like that would be love in the name of Christ.
Oh, God. It's ridiculous.
Which is defined as, quote, defacing, damaging, polluting, or otherwise physically mistreating in a way the actor knows will outrage the sensibilities of persons likely to observe or discover the action.
Well, okay. So that doesn't sound like a law that should exist in the United States.
No, it doesn't. But it's only because it's nebulously written. Like, defacing something that's not yours, that should not be legal, right? Damaging something that's not yours, that should not be legal. Polluting something, I'm using all the words from the statute here.
But damaging a statue of Jesus Christ should cost you the cost of repairing
the statue, not 2 years in prison.
Right. I mean, if you've defaced it, you need to make it right. And I think that to some extent, you need to sort of make people happy in the way that you do it. There's some things that just don't matter. Like taking a picture near it. Like what is defiling? This clearly is. But what if he'd just gone and put his arm over the shoulder and acted like he's buddy-buddy with Jesus?
Well, I think the most nebulous part of this is the next word, which is physically, otherwise physically mistreating, the next several words there, in a way the actor knows will outrage the sensibilities of persons likely to observe or discover the action. So that's, if they're going to be convicting him on something, that would be the area, right? Because he's not defacing, damaging, or polluting the statue by pumping it,
right,
or whatever it was that he was doing.
Basically,
he is not. So the question is, what is the definition of physical mistreatment? What's the legal definition of that? What do you consider physical mistreatment? I mean, that can mean anything, from what I can tell.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a very general set of terms there. And so he's been charged with desecration of a venerated object. It is a charge that was often used against people who burnt American flags in protest.
Which, so, I mean, I think that just about everyone will agree is a constitutional right.
No, I don't know if everyone. Everyone will agree with that, Mark. This is the flag you're talking about. People, their logic goes out the window when you talk about this object. It's sacred to people.
Well, yeah. Yes.
There's less than 50% of people support flag burning.
Oh, I'm not asking you whether you support it or not. I'm asking whether you consider it to be constitutional. Okay. Do you agree with me? Do you disagree with me that the burning of the American flag is a constitutionally protected act? Now, I'm not
asking. So long as it is your American flag.
I'm not asking about, you know, somebody else's flag. I'm asking about your flag and potentially on property that you own or control.
Totally protected. Or it
yes,
should be.
And I think that every court that has looked at this has said the same thing. That's why I'm saying that everybody who, you know, isn't mentally ill thinks that this is constitutionally protected. They may not like it, but it's protected.
No, I get your point there. But that's why they have laws like this, so they can get around those obvious free speech violations. Now they can just simply say that, well, you know, this is our law here, and it's desecrated a venerated object. People venerate this object. It's been desecrated. 2 years in prison.
Good enough.
And they've used this charge against people who burn American flags in protest. I don't know how successful they were with those, but I imagine they were successful because if someone doesn't challenge it, if they just pay the fine and they take the plea deal, then there is no way to uphold the Constitution or to uphold free speech. So to uphold those things requires someone who's willing to go through the court process and someone who's willing to go all the way to the Supreme Court, which can be a multi-year-long journey and very, very expensive journey. In Texas v. Johnson, Johnson was charged with desecration of a venerated object for burning an American flag during the 1984 Republican National Convention in Dallas.
Good job, Johnson.
The case brought to light questions about whether or not expressive acts were protected under the amendment. The Supreme Court ultimately decided that the burning of the flag in protest was, in fact, protected speech, since it was done in an expressive manner with obvious political intentions. It's important to note that any act may be protected or not, depending on context and intention. For example, if a flag was burned in protest, it's protected speech. If it was burned as an act of vandalism, it's not, which makes sense because then it wouldn't be your flag and then it would be property destruction in that case. If the young man was expressing his distaste for the church, then legally, this is the opinion of the freethoughtproject.com, then legally, per our Constitution, these charges must be dropped. However, that won't stop them from continuing on with the prosecution. And I sure hope this young man is going to be lawyering up rather than cutting a deal, because I'm sure the way it's going to go is the way it goes for almost every teenager, is they scare the crap out of them with the court system, and then they offer them a plea deal, and look, buddy, all right, you're faced with this serious 2 years in prison over desecration of a venerated object. Tell you what, we'll reduce the charge to a violation-level disorderly conduct, and you can get 6 months probation. How about that, kid?
Sounds right.
So I have a little factoid for you guys. So apparently...
factoid is not necessarily true, but in some cases...
Okay, well, a fact then. In 2003...
Bit of trivia.
a small fact. A factlet.
It's true. The word factoid has become to mean something that is actually a fact, but a not very important fact. Right. But ultimately, the original definition was something that appears to be a fact, but is not true, from what I understand. Yeah.
On June 27th, 2006, the Senate voted down a proposed flag desecration amendment by the slimmest margin ever. The vote was 66 to 34.
An amendment.
Wow. To the Constitution. Yeah.
But that doesn't end it when the Senate votes.
Sure.
Yeah. The vote was 66 to 34 and was just one vote short of the two-thirds needed to approve a constitutional amendment.
Wow. That's
for
shocking.
The Senate.
One vote of destroying free speech.
Would have made it federally illegal to burn the flag, is what you're saying, or do anything to the flag that's like not within the certain parameters of you've got to fold it in a specific way, and it has to be lit up if it's outside at night.
And this is according to the ACLU.
So like anything outside of that would probably be considered desecration.
The problem
right?
with politics, though, Johnson, is that I almost feel like these votes are sometimes set up before they're made. Like, you know, the team captains go through, they count their folks, and they say, you know, we know this is going to pass, but we're going to let 65 of our the ones whose elections are in the balance, we're going to let them vote for it, but then we've got our 36 people that are going to vote against it, and we're good. I don't know. I mean, I'm skeptical when it comes to politics, whether who thought what at any given time. I'll bet you there are people that wanted to vote yes for it that voted no because they were told to, and people that wanted to vote no for it that voted yes because they were told to. I have no clue what this means. This is the problem with dealing with liars.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I agree. And apparently, unfortunately, they've been considering it again. At least this is from...
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'll make America better. We're in the throes of the Great Recession here. We could just eke our way out by outlawing the burning of the flag.
Well, it's not actually... apparently, when they're considering it again, it's not just the flag. It's also burning a copy of the Constitution would fall into the same.
Well, there you go.
Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. I'm just curious. Back to the story here about the teenager who is facing 2 years... for a Facebook photo where he's simulating a sex act with Jesus. What if you were to just, pretend like you're hanging off a cross, too? Would that also be desecrating the object? I mean, there's all kinds of things that can offend people.
Not on Easter. That is a passion play.
Well, what about the favorite pastime of both Christians and Muslims, burning the Quran or burning the Bible?
855-450-FREE.
Attention. Renew is currently seeking participants who are dealing with stress and unhappiness. If you are experiencing one or more of the following symptoms, you are eligible to participate in the trial and receive a free 2-week supply of the mood-boosting supplement, Renew. To be eligible, your symptoms may include fatigue, hopelessness, tension, negative mood, anxiety, or lack of sleep. Renew is an all-natural, doctor-recommended supplement that will help boost your mood and give you more energy right away. Renew has been featured on Oprah and The View and has already helped over 1 million people feel better naturally. Now you are eligible to participate in the free trial if you or someone you know are experiencing symptoms of stress and unhappiness. Call now to participate in the trial and receive a free 2-week supply of Renew.
To participate in the Renew trial and get a free supply, call 1-800-553-7444. 1-800-553-7444. Call 1-800-553-7444. 1-800-553-7444.
Adam Miller here with Midas Resources. Today, September 10th, 2014, gold opened at $1,249.40. A 1 ounce gold coin can be purchased for $1,295.12, $647.56 for a half ounce, or $323.78 for a quarter ounce. That's $1,295.12, $647.56, and $323.78.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? Wait a sec. Gold and silver is going up while Congress is trying to settle on the next debt increase. And there's no end to this madness. That old 401k and IRA can be converted into physical gold without tax consequences. I explained this in my book, 10 Reasons to Buy Gold. Don't let time slip away. Call for your free copy today, 800-686-2237. Get away from that Washington spin and get honest answers about gold. 800-686-2237. The book is free, 800-686-2237.
Free Talk Live.
For me, it's fighting negativity, and the negativity is my thoughts in my head that are negative. And I had to learn to recognize when my thoughts were being negative, because most of my life, most of my thoughts were negative.
Mm-hmm.
So I had to become aware of when they were happening. And when I become aware of these negative thoughts pervading my thinking, I immediately fight them with positive thoughts. And most of the positive thoughts that I feed myself are positive affirmations about who I am, where I'm going, where I've come from.
Whenever I find myself thinking negatively, I don't consider it fighting the negative thoughts. I just consider it changing my train of thought. I just kind of change tracks to a positive thought and just focus on that.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Khalid lives in Gaza. He makes his living as a taxi driver. The engine in his old beater blew up. Now, he makes good money driving people in his cab, but he couldn't afford the $1,300 for a new engine. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the engine, and he's back on the road. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference. One cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. Coffee.freetalklive.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Just because it's tacky doesn't mean it should be illegal. There's a 17-year-old male who's currently facing 2 years in prison for having a Facebook photo taken of him in a sexual position with a kneeling statue of Jesus. And so you can probably figure it out what was going on there. You're welcome to share your thoughts on what should happen in this case. I thought there was an interesting comment on our Facebook page. I'm going to share that here in a moment. The toll-free number for you is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And don't forget to join us via Skype as well. I just got a request from somebody earlier. Send a request to username lrn.fm. It'll be approved, and then it'll be easy for you to call us on Skype, and you'll sound way better usually on Skype than you would if you called us on the phones. And I want you to know about freedomsphoenix.com. They're uncovering the secrets and exposing the lies, and that's what you get every day over at freedomsphoenix.com. Readers of freedomsphoenix.com are constantly provided the detailed real news that lies between the lines of propaganda and the relationship we have with coercive governments. freedomsphoenix.com offers up-to-the-minute updates on the economy, technology, communications, and the rise of the police state. They do good work over there at freedomsphoenix.com. You can sign up for their free daily dispatch. So the story was actually posted earlier this afternoon, Mark, by you, I think, over at our Facebook and Google Plus and Twitter, which you can access, by the way, by going to news.freetalklive.com. And you posted it earlier, so there have been quite a few comments posted on this story about the young man who's facing prison time over a tacky picture. It's something that teenage boys are wont to do, to do silly things, exerting their sexuality on statues. In this case, no damage was done to the statue. No one has claimed that any damage was done to the statue. The only damage in some people's minds is just that. It's in their minds.
And
it's offensive.
I would think that this young man is also expressing to some extent his religious beliefs. He's not a believer in the Judeo-Christian Abrahamic tradition.
Who knows? He might be a Satanist.
That would be somebody who believed in that. It could
That's
be.
Right.
The chances of him being a Satanist are far
Pretty
less
low.
Than him being an atheist.
That's true.
Most people, many people claiming to be Satanists are in fact atheists. And then there's all the atheists that are atheist, and a great deal of the agnostics who are in fact atheists too. So you've got this large pool of people who are atheists compared to this small pool of people that are Satanists.
So here's the quote that I like from Facebook. Renee Pinto made this comment earlier today. She said, pretty sure the person in the statue, that is Jesus, would just say to forgive the guy and carry on with life and love. What irony if he gets incarcerated by the owner of the statue. Do they not know that guy's philosophy?
Well, I don't know how much the owner gets to say about it.
That's a good question. Did the owner report it to the police, or did some offended citizen report it, and then the police just went ahead and took action without the consent of the owner?
Well, I think that the owner probably wants to be made whole in some way, but what we found over time here in Free Talk Live
is damage.
I understand. They feel like they're damaged.
Uh-huh.
I said made whole in some way.
You're presuming that the owner feels that way, but okay.
I am. Yeah, what I suspect is that this young man could do, an afternoon's work at the church, on the church grounds, cleaning up or something like that.
Or whatever.
And that suddenly things would be made right. And then that would be an opportunity to do some discipleship for the church. They could act like a bunch of overbearing jerks, but they'd probably be better off showing this person the love of Jesus. And, they have the opportunity to do some conversion. This would be a really great opportunity for this church if that's what they chose to do. But the state has gotten involved. And like we've seen so many times, like every time the state gets involved, they got to get their piece of it. Mm-hmm. It's like there's a story out from my town where a dog gets loose and kills some chickens. They issue a fine to the dog owner that then gets paid to the state for the owner
guy's
gets
still
nothing.
Out his chickens.
Right.
That's how crazy it is. And it's like that everywhere. And it's very rare that you'll hear about restitution being ordered, although it does happen in New Hampshire courts, Mark. I have seen restitution be ordered in some cases. I don't know why it's applied to some cases and why not to others. But regardless, but to me, there's no restitution owed in this case. You don't deserve restitution because you were offended, because somebody did something you didn't like. You could claim that he trespassed on the property, but then again, it was probably open to the public, and he had no idea that it was, you know, it's probably not a no trespassing zone. So he likely didn't trespass.
He did it during the day.
Yeah, that's true. It's bright daylight out during this photo. And even if he'd done it at night, it wouldn't that wouldn't make it more illegal simply because it was nighttime. No damage was done, so therefore no restitution is owed, in my opinion.
I disagree. I think that that this brazen act of desecration of this formed piece of rock does put him into some debt to the church organization. And I think that an afternoon worth of, painting a fence or something like that
would be... What do you think, Johnson? Does this young man owe restitution to the church?
No. I mean, why should he? He didn't damage anything.
Right. Somebody gets offended. So, Mark, are you saying every time somebody's offended about someone's behavior,
I'm not talking about
that they're
owed
restitution?
I'm not talking about offense. I'm talking about trespassing. He committed
the
offense.
He wasn't warned. It's not trespassing unless you're told it's trespassing.
When you go on somebody's property and you hump their venerated object, you know what you're doing. At that point, he has used the property in a manner that he knew from the very beginning, unless he's some kind of brain-addled twit. Mm-hmm. He knew that he was going on this property to defile their rock. And this is their rock, not his rock. So, yes, they have created some kind of mental damage, as it were, to their special
rock. I think
rock.
That's opening up a Pandora's box.
Well,
man.
I think what the clear course of action here is that the church now says that he's banned from the property. That's it. Done.
Yeah, that would be an appropriate thing to where then if he came back after he had been warned, then it's trespassing.
I think he should
then
spend...
Then there's a tort.
I think he should spend an afternoon painting a fence. Look, here at the studio...
there's no damage. He didn't damage them in any way.
I've heard
so
that
So now
argument.
He can say... Now they can say that he's banned, right? And they can also publicly embarrass him if they so want to, if the community cares. And there's their restitution. That's all that... If they want to say that, maybe they can Photoshop a picture of it the other way around.
What if
with Jesus in the standing position
sure
and
Jesus
him in the kneeling position? And there you go. There's your restitution.
I think that the young man should make good on this for humping their special rock.
So you're arbitrarily picking out the number of an afternoon's worth of painting.
And then what do you do about all the Muslims and the Christians who have been burning the religious holy scriptures of the other one?
What do you do with them? They own them. They're not on their property. See, the reason this is a lesser included offense of trespassing, in my opinion. If he had trespassed, if they had put their special magic rock on public property, then I would have no problem.
What? Wait a minute. That doesn't make sense because it's still their rock. Even if it's on public property, it's still their property, is it not?
I don't think it does.
Are you saying they would have donated it to the public?
It's an abandoned rock at that point. That rock becomes public because it is on public property. Mm-hmm. They can maintain it, but, it is what it is.
Well, Mark, so you're saying that you think he should do a day's worth or an afternoon's worth of painting or some other menial task at the church. But what if other people think he should do a week's worth or 2 months' worth? I mean, it's all just completely arbitrary, isn't it? What is it worth? The defiling of a holy object. This should be years' worth of painting. I mean, this is Jesus we're talking about here. Why aren't you taking this seriously enough, Mark? One afternoon is not enough.
Lop his head off.
Stand by with that. We'll get into it here in a moment. I want to hear how you feel. Is there a restitution that this young man owes? Besides maybe an apology, if that, 855-450-FREE.
Attention all listeners. Are you ready for a free stock market webinar with PhilsGang.com? Join us September 13th at 12 noon Eastern for this live PhilsGang.com free webinar valued at $75. You'll learn how to protect your principal in this Federal Reserve-controlled low-interest rate market by identifying moves before they happen. To register, simply go to LearnStocksForFree.com. LearnStocksForFree.com. Or call 877-600-4264. Promo code GCN. 877-600-4264. Promo code GCN.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Do you need access to money? Do you need cash today? If you are receiving a structured settlement due to a lawsuit, or you are receiving pension payments over a long period of time, the Money Settlement Hotline can get you instant funding now. With your cash today, you can pay off credit card debt, pay medical bills, fund your education, or improve your home. You don't need to wait. It's true. If you're receiving a structured settlement or pension payment spread out over time and you want a lump sum amount immediately, then you need to call now. They will turn your long-term structured settlement or pension payments into a lump sum larger cash payout, so you'll get all of your money instantly. If you have a structured settlement or pension and you want cash today, call the Money Settlement Hotline right now. 888-785-0616. 888-785-0616. 888-785-0616. That's 888-785-0616.
How many lawyers does it take to change a light bulb? None. They'd rather keep their clients in the dark. There are too many lawyer jokes to count. However, there are some lawyers with more noble intentions. At the Institute for Justice, we bring the light to our clients. We are a nonprofit public interest law firm with clear values and principles. At IJ, we fight for those whose most basic rights are denied by the government. Visit our website today at ij.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement, and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary at fpp.cc, as well as weekly news in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com. The monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc, and books at shop.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free here. Bring up anything you want. The number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Just go to freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features waiting for you there. You can actually vote and submit content right there to the front page of the site. It works pretty well. It's based in Reddit, and so therefore it is free. So go to freetalklive.com. And if you value your online privacy, you need to know about ProXPN. ProXPN is a global virtual private network. They encrypt your online data, meaning your internet service provider, as soon as you connect to ProXPN, will no longer be able to track or know what you're doing online. They will have no clue. It'll all be encrypted. It'll just, your ISP at that point will just be a pass-through. They'll just be passing along all this encrypted data. And what they're probably doing, if you don't have ProXPN, is logging all the websites you visit and all the search terms you enter. In some cases, those logs are kept for up to 5 years. So you can stop that by going to proxpn.com/FTL.
and you can get started with their software. It's free to download. Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, Android devices, and even Linux users can use ProXPN. Those setups a little bit different for Linux. Use code FTL50 at proxpn.com/FTL. Code FTL50 gets you 50% off the price of their annual account, which drops the price to about $5 per month, which is an awesome price for the privacy protection you're getting. Because with the premium account, you get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world you can connect to, private torrenting ability, plus you can get past regionally blocked websites. And if 50% off the annual account isn't good enough for you, well, get your Bitcoin wallet out, because you can get 62% off with Bitcoin when you buy the annual plan, and you pay with this discount code, FTLBTC. That's FTL like Free Talk Live, and then BTC like Bitcoin. So go to proxpn.com/FTL. Go and get started there for free tonight. And then don't forget promo code FTL50 and FTLBTC. There's a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. And ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits at all. It's a great discount on privacy that's priceless. ProXPN.com/FTL. Let's go to Niall, listening in Raleigh to Talk Radio 850. Hey, Niall, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, how you doing?
Good, good. We're talking about the young man who's facing prison time over a photo that he posted to Facebook of him essentially engaging in a simulated sexual act with his clothes on in front of a Jesus statue, and wondering what folks think about that. Go ahead.
Well, it goes to the what is freedom of expression, what is freedom of speech? Are you allowed to stick your face in somebody else's and loudly say a racial or ethnic epithet right in their face? You know, maybe give them a little spray while you're at it. You know, that's speech.
No, I would say that would be inappropriate, because then you would be cutting into that person's personal space, and spitting on them, of course, would be an assault.
Where's the personal space mentioned in the constitutional decisions legalizing outrages? That's basically what it is like, it's an outrage to common civilized peace. You know, it's like a disturbance of the peace. If you want to do something to get people really mad and upset, you know, that's fine.
You realize that it is legal to call people racial epithets loudly. Like, you realize that that's actually legal?
Well, he was talking about getting in someone's face.
You can't get in someone's face and spit on them, but you can scream at people and say nasty things.
No. You're wrong. That is not legal. That is an assault. That's assault.
Just to clarify, I think you guys are miscommunicating. What Niall said originally was that it was getting up in someone's face, and that would be assault by spitting on them. But, Johnson, what you were saying is if the person was
just spraying and loud, being really loud at them, you know?
Hold on. Are you saying – just to clarify, Niall, because what Johnson was saying was that if you were a few feet away from the person and shouting, that would be completely legal. Don't you agree with that?
No, I don't think so. I think if you go to like New York City and go into Harlem, or say go to Ferguson and yell racial epithets at people on the street, you know, is that legal?
I think you have illegal and highly unwise confused.
People have been arrested for disturbing the peace for much less.
Well, disturbing the peace disturbing the peace is really a crappy catch-all charge. It is highly unwise to yell racial epithets, especially at a racially disadvantaged individual, because there's, you know, all this baggage there. I don't know what legal and illegal is in this circumstance, but I don't think that it seems like freedom of speech would cover that.
Yeah, I'm no attorney, but this is pretty clear free speech. And for instance, you know, look at the classic example of the KKK march in, was it Skokie, Illinois, many years ago. That was obviously completely legal, though quite offensive. And, of course, we know that the bedrock principle of the First Amendment, the idea is that it's the offensive speech that needs to be protected. You don't have a right not to be offended. And that's why I'm saying that the young man doesn't owe anybody for what he did to the statue. He didn't damage it. All he did was, you know, some people's feelings got hurt. Well, it doesn't matter if his intentions were to hurt someone's feelings. You control how you feel. You control how you react to things. And putting the onus of control on someone else, saying that, well, someone else did something, so I reacted this way, and so therefore it's their fault how I reacted, that's nonsense.
Yeah, well, that's basically your, you know, lawyer you're kind of doing a legalese interpretation of it. What I'm saying is, would he do that? Like, would he get in a sexual position with a Quran, you know? And
maybe he would.
On Facebook
with this is
his
just
ID?
A teenager. He's a teenager. Why would he care
just
if it was a Quran?
Just because he's doing that to a statue doesn't make him Islamic.
Like, it goes back to, like, the piss Jesus, you know, or piss Christ that they did in New York, that think that artist. That
also not illegal. I mean, well, offensive, yeah, but not illegal.
It used to be illegal. Remember when at the beginning of the United States, if you said anything insulting or did anything really gross to somebody, they'd call you out for a duel and kill you, you know?
I support the right of free people to decide if they want to engage in a duel or not. I've come down on the other side of the issue with the Piss Christ piece of art, because as far as I know, he owned everything that was in that. Whereas on this circumstance,
wasn't the I hate saying that word on the air. Wasn't the Piss Christ thing?
Yeah.
It's not illegal.
It's the name of a piece of art.
It's the name of the 1987 photograph by American artist Andre Serrano.
I thought that the controversy around that was that there was some sort of government art money that went into
there was that. And I think that's despicable, but that's not really the issue that most people have. Most people are like, he shouldn't be able to say that.
You're in a position where what you're doing is you're going with constitutional decisions that were made often at the behest of some organization like the American Civil Liberties Union or other fine communist organizations.
What are you talking about? The ACLU, this is ridiculous.
People.
It's ridiculous to call the ACLU communists, sir. It's ridiculous.
I wonder if people were calling them when they were defending Rush Limbaugh, you know. Or,
the ACLU, you mean?
Yeah, when they were. Yeah.
The ACLU. Look, the ACLU is an organization that has certain constitutional principles that they work very hard to uphold. And sometimes that crosses some people's offense. They don't like certain individuals or groups that the ACLU will come to defend. It's like the ACLU would be the kind of group who would defend the KKK marching in Skokie, Illinois. It doesn't mean they agree with the content of the march. It doesn't mean that if they're defending communists that they agree with communists. I've had the ACLU defend me in court. And they did a fine job. They were defending me on a freedom of speech issue, or in this case, a freedom of the press issue, where I was arrested at a Palmer, Massachusetts town hall building for holding a video camera. And the ACLU paid for basically the attorney to represent me in that case. And that had nothing to do with being a communist or, you know, who in the ACLU might be a communist. It's just ridiculous hate that is thrown at that organization.
Yeah. Civil liberties is a pretty good thing, and they're usually on the right side of those issues from what I've seen. Look, I'm as much of a social conservative as the next guy in my own life, but I don't think I think that people's human rights are more important. And in this circumstance, Johnson, you did say you had a question for me.
He does have a question, but it's a long question, so we're going to hold back on that here in a moment. We'll get to the question. Your calls come first. Johnson can wait. 855-453.
Before we move on real quick, now this isn't a question. I just want to clarify that. I think it needs to be clarified that assault it actually involves a threat of bodily harm.
Well, then maybe it was battery. I don't know what it would be, but spitting on somebody is definitely a personal property rights violation. There's more coming up here. It's Free Talk Live.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Oh, fall. A time for cooler temperatures and hot deals from America's Best Value Inn. Save 15% when you book a room online at americasbestvalueinn.com and stay now through October 23rd. Plus, you'll enjoy free continental breakfast, internet, and instant rewards through our Value Club at most of our 1,000 hotels in North America. Fall into savings this season at America's Best Value Inn.
I didn't believe it.
Neither did I.
No way could you professionally remove unwanted hair, pain-free, and at home.
My thoughts exactly.
Remove my face and body hair without expensive, painful office visits?
Not possible. Great minds think alike.
Until I tried No-No Pro.
Mm-hmm. Wait, you tried No-No?
Yes, and it works. I use it on my face, legs, bikini line.
We're BFFs, and you didn't tell me about No-No?
Here, this is my new No-No Pro. The most powerful No-No made. Custom treatment levels, less hair and less time. Perfect for any skin type. Try it.
No hair, no pain, no time-consuming expensive office visits?
No, no, and No-No.
For a limited time, you can try No-No Pro risk-free. You'll also get the facial kit and a travel case. Get weeks of long-lasting results.
That's it. I'm getting a No-No.
Great minds do think alike.
Try No-No Pro risk-free by calling 800-952-5760. 800-952-5760. That's 800-952-5760. 800-952-5760.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything. We'll defend free speech, even though some of the people who engage in it are distasteful. And
highly.
Yeah. And some would argue that that includes me. There was a video I posted to freekeen.com today that some people are upset about involving me and one of the parking enforcers in town. So it was not liked what I said to the parking enforcer. We could play that later if we get a chance. Our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. Plus, Johnson has a question for Mark. We'll get to that. And your calls and thoughts are certainly welcome. You can also join us via Skype. Username there is lrn.fm. Hey, Mark, how do you get a free pound of coffee?
It's easy. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com and get a free pound of BuzzBox coffee. It's shade-grown, 100% organic, and top 1% grade Arabica beans. Now, you can get either ground or unground, and how you want it ground and all that stuff is a possibility. I think the free pound comes the way they send the free pound, but nonetheless, you can, after you continue on with the subscription there at coffee.freetalklive.com, you can get all kinds of different stuff. The decaf isn't available, sadly, for the folks to get the free pound, but I do get the decaf through coffee.freetalklive.com. It's delicious, just as good as the regular coffee. And what's really great about BuzzBox is that they allow Free Talk Live to give microloans to families around the world. So for every 10 people that get their coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, we're able to give another microloan to another family around the world. And that's every single month. So, and then those loans, as they're paid back, get compounded. We're really creating something in the world, and I'm really excited about it. Please, be a part of it. You drink coffee already. Drink better coffee and give somebody a hand up out of poverty. Coffee.freetalklive.com.
It's a great idea. Let's continue here, and we'll get to Johnson's question for you in a moment, Mark. But first, Julia is on the line in California. You're on Free Talk Live, Julia, via Skype. We have Julia in California.
Hi.
Hello there. You're on the air.
Hi. What do you think about how emotional people get about 9/11?
You know, I haven't encountered it today, thank goodness. What are you seeing? Can you give us an example?
Just pictures of, like, remember.
Yeah, like, always remember.
9/11 and
terrorist hunting permit.
Those people are heroes.
Well, I mean, it's to be expected. I mean, most people in America are not of the understanding that freedom could be the solution rather than sending military men over and creating another terrorist attack down the line, and more and more and more as more people are murdered, as apparently Barack Obama plans to continue murdering people in the Middle East. We haven't gotten to that in detail yet here tonight, but he gave some sort of speech last night outlining his plan for more war. So unfortunately,
in war, innocents die.
Did something special happen on 9/11 or something? I think I forgot.
Yeah, it's been a long time. It, of course, you know, we're talking about 9/11-2001 for anybody who has been in a cave and not paying attention to what day it is. But yeah, it's frustrating.
Well, I feel bad for the people that died on 9/11, but I always feel like the remember thing is about vengeance. Mm. It's not about, to me, it's not really, it doesn't seem to be about anything else. It always seems to be about, don't forget who did this to us. Mm. And I don't. You know, I don't know the answers to all these the questions as to who did what, but it seems like the United States did what the terrorists wanted them to do, which was
destroy freedom,
run off into the Middle East, destroy freedom here at home, spend so much money that it cripples the economy. I mean, you know,
well,
it's strange that the war on terror came right before the largest economic downturn in, you know, nearly 100 years.
I think it's important to clarify something, Mark. You said the United States government did what the terrorists wanted them to do. But what you mean is the United States government did what they were saying the terrorists want them to do, right? Because the U.S. government's line is they want to destroy your freedom. They hate you for your freedom. They hate you for McDonald's and Britney Spears, and that's why they're trying to kill us all. So we need to go over there and get them before they get us. That was their story. But if you actually listen to Osama bin Laden and what he had to say, now, obviously, he may not speak for all terrorists, but if you listen to some of their words, the new guy, not just Osama bin Laden, the British guy who's been ostensibly beheading people over there, it's all the same message. Leave us alone. So in that case, no, if you actually listen to what the supposed terrorists say, they're saying leave us alone. The United States did not do that.
Well, Osama bin Laden is quoted as saying, "We are continuing this policy and bleeding America to the point of bankruptcy. Allah willing, and nothing is too great for Allah." So what his goal apparently was to get the United States involved in these wars so that it would bleed it economically.
Well, that may be their policy now that the wars are continuing, but the original request was, please stop bombing us. Stop killing our family members over here, and we'll leave you alone. I mean, that was the original request, and the United States government
did not do that. There weren't that many killings going on before 9/11 over there. What it was an occupation. They didn't like the United States being there. It wasn't the death. It was the policing of the illegitimate policing of that area.
Well, they were meddling in the politics.
I don't think Osama bin Laden gives a flying flip at a rolling donut at who dies. I really don't think he does. But he will use the outrage over would have used the outrage over death to get what he wanted.
Sure. Anyway, go ahead, Julia. Any other thoughts you want to share? Thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate it.
Talk to her into the dirt.
Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's continue. Tom is in New Hampshire. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Tom.
Oh, by the way, I think you were misinformed there. That guy, he's not getting busted for disturbing the peace. What he's getting busted for is statutory rape. Anyway, I want to point something. I was just thinking, you know what would be wicked funny? If some country like Kenya decides that they're going to impose their income tax on every citizen of the country, no matter where in the world they live, and they're going to impose citizenship if you were born there or if your mother or father was born there. Because you take a look at that long-form birth certificate that President Obama posted on the White House website there. Sure enough, he was born in Honolulu, Hawaii, all right, but his father was born in Kenya. And that means that the bureaucrats in Nairobi have authority to impose upon President Barack Obama, as the child of a Kenyan born overseas, all of the duties of citizenship, including having to pay taxes. They get to decide how much of his money he gets to keep, and he has to file all these lengthy reports about his foreign non-Kenya bank accounts with the bureaucrats in Kenya, just like the United States government is doing to United States so-called citizens who live in Kenya or anywhere else in the world. Wouldn't that be wicked funny?
Well, it'd certainly be. It just goes to show how ludicrous the whole government citizenship thing is. Many people want U.S. citizenship, but there are drawbacks to it. There's no doubt. You go around the world, the U.S. government decides, oh, yeah, you owe us money no matter where you – if you make more than $90,000 a year, you owe us money.
Thanks for the call, Tom. Our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. A lot of people, I think, are frustrated by these 9/11 remember memorial posts that are being popping up all over the place. I don't watch television, so I don't know how bad it's been there, but I imagine there's been some – programming choices there.
I heard some on NPR on the way in, and I'm just like, oh god. Well, today's the day for it.
I saw a very interesting webcomic from Cyanide and Happiness, which is like this, they just do these stick figure kind of comic comics where it shows a time traveler who comes out of like a time portal, and he's like, what's the date today? And the guy's like, it's September 10th, 2001. And he's like, there's still time. And then he goes and it shows him at the a stock exchange. And he's like, put all my money on Apple.
Yeah.
The thing about these remembrance things is it always seems over and over again to be used as a cudgel to
blame the Muslims.
Well, against Muslims, more aggressive U.S.
Stir
foreign
up
policy.
For war. Yeah,
and it's not that I don't feel terrible for
you think it was a whole...
all those rescue dogs that died in 9/11 or whatever happened, but people are using it, and the media is using it too. Oh well, not that much going on in the news. You can believe if something exciting was happening in the news, some celebrity had released a sex tape or whatever, that would be the front story. But no, it's 9/11, and not that much is going on. We'll use this.
Awfully coincidental that Barack Obama gave his little speech just before 9/11, right? Like perfect time of the year to start stirring up support for a new war. From what I understand, according to the AP, Obama to send 475 additional troops to Iraq, and he's got even more plans to commence some more killing in the name of freedom. 855-450-FREE.
And he ran on promising peace.
855-450-3733. Old George Bush ran on no nation building, so right. They're all the same. You can take control.
America
here.
Loves its liars.
Hour number two is on the way. Plenty of time for your calls and thoughts, whether it's about the statue situation or ISIS or whatever. Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Khalid lives in Gaza. He makes his living as a taxi driver. The engine in his old beater blew up. Now, he makes good money driving people in his cab, but he couldn't afford the $1,300 for a new engine. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the engine, and he's back on the road. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums.
I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Thursday, September 11th, 2014. Silver is trading at $18.78 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,243 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $476. Antiwar.com reports Iraqi Kurdistan's political leadership, under intense pressure from the Obama administration, gave its backing to the new Iraqi central government, but that doesn't mean they're on board unconditionally, and the big issue of oil revenue remains unresolved. The Kurdistan regional government has rejected the proposed Abadi government oil plan, which is to pay installments on past oil exports to the Kurdish government going forward. The KRG has owed nearly $8 billion since January, when Iraq cut them off from promised oil payments over export disputes. The Kurds tried to export oil on their own to make up the difference, but threats of lawsuits by Iraq have made buyers tough to come by. Iraq maintains they just don't have the money anymore because of their budget shortfall, and is also trying to condition the installment payments on Kurdistan agreeing to once again give the central government a monopoly on production and exports of oil. Abadi may have the Kurds on board for the time being, but there is no guarantee they will remain there if the oil dispute, as well as the territorial disputes over Kirkuk, remain unresolved. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. The New York Times reports demonstrators hoping to block Interstate 70 in Ferguson, Missouri on Wednesday to protest the fatal shooting of Michael Brown a month ago were barred by the police from entering the highway. Local officials said 35 people had been arrested, most for unlawful assembly, but four for assaulting officers. The demonstrators were outnumbered by more than 100 officers from three law enforcement agencies. One demonstrator, Charles Brooks, was among those who sat down on the road shouting, "McCulloch got to go. McCulloch got to go." A reference to the St. Louis County prosecutor, Robert P. McCulloch, whose office is investigating the shooting. The demonstration took place about 5 miles from the street in Ferguson where Brown was killed by police officer Darren Wilson on August 9th. Some witnesses had said Brown had put his hands up in surrender. Wilson has not been charged and has been placed on leave. The demonstration was meant to last 4.5 hours, symbolizing the death of Brown and the amount of time that his body laid in the street after his death. Organizers had hoped to pressure Governor Jay Nixon to appoint a special prosecutor to lead the investigation of the killing. During the 2013 Porcupine Freedom Festival, Davi Barker presented an idea for a renegade psychological experiment. Since then, he has refined his idea and put his plan and research into writing. He explains, "We aim to show the world beyond a shadow of a doubt that power corrupts absolutely and corrupt authority deserves no obedience." Authoritarian Sociopathy is available from Amazon.com and all major bookstores.
Antiwar.com reports, in his highly anticipated Wednesday night speech, President Obama was light on details but long on ambition for his open-ended war on ISIS, which is now expanding from Iraq into neighboring Syria. The speech focused on hyping the danger of ISIS, which Obama insisted had no vision and has to be destroyed, while laying out a war he says will follow the strategy of the Yemen and Somali air wars, except dramatically bigger. Yemen and Somalia have seen intermittent U.S. airstrikes that have not actually accomplished anything on the ground. The main resemblance the ISIS war is expected to have are the open-ended duration and lack of an endgame strategy. While he publicly hasn't confirmed the plans yet, expanding the war from Iraq into neighboring Syria also seems a foregone conclusion at this point, as officials have been downplaying the idea that they could stop ISIS in one country without stopping them planet-wide. A global war with no strategy for victory and no end in sight certainly wasn't what the American public were presented with when the campaign began, but White House officials continue to deny that mission creep is occurring. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The number of users who actually enjoy Facebook is down to 4. And Apple announces a new iPhone with the N-word on the back, knowing customers will buy it anyway. And now for the delayed and utterly thoughtless romantic gesture that is The Onion Week in Review. Self-identified 9/11 truther Dennis Shaw told reporters Tuesday he's absolutely convinced the United States government has orchestrated an intricate plot to systematically destroy the last 11 years of his life. Shaw, who since 2001 has spent nearly every waking minute poring over footage of the World Trade Center attack and even handing out truther pamphlets every afternoon, says the government is behind the gradual collapse of his personal and professional life, adding that the conspiracy, quote, goes all the way to the top.
Before 2001, I'd see my friend Stephen Copley every couple of weeks, and now he won't even answer my calls. The government got to him too. Think about it. My coworkers, my wife, my friends, everyone calling me crazy after September 11th and wanting nothing to do with me. What are the chances of that?
This is the Onion News Network.
Show is Free Talk Live. We're here to take your calls about anything that you want. Toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. You can Skype into the show. Our username there is lrn.fm. Joining you in the studio tonight, it's Ian.
And Johnson.
And Mark.
So, Johnson, you had a question that you wanted to ask Mark, but we're going to need to recap briefly here. We were talking about property. And property rights when it comes to stuff you donate. Because Mark had brought up this question about
desecration of a venerated object.
Yeah, so what had happened originally was we were talking about an issue with a teenager. He's 17. He's charged with desecration of a venerated object in Pennsylvania for having a photo taken of him having a sexual position with a kneeling Christ statue. And that was offensive to some people, and the question kind of the conversation we had evolved into a discussion, a larger discussion about property. And, you know, Mark, you said this was wrong for him to do this on someone's private property, and he therefore owed some sort of restitution. Johnson and I disagreed with that, saying that no damage was done. If somebody's offended by it, well, then, as Johnson pointed out, and I think rightly so, they can issue a no trespass notice now that they know that this young man may be a problem child and they don't want him on their property. Of course, as was pointed out on Facebook, the right thing to do for a Christian, ostensibly Christian church would be to forgive the young man and move on. But so everybody's got a different position on this. It led to another question about, well, what if the statue wasn't on private property but was in point of fact on public property? Would that change whether or not it would be legal to hump the statue? And then, Johnson, you have a related question.
So the question that I have is, and this is something that I had intent to do and still sort of have intent to do. I haven't gotten around to it, but there is a you can get like Avery labels and where you can print your own labels and whatnot. And
yeah.
When every time I've stayed at a hotel, you know, I'm very offended by the fact that there's always these Bibles. And
is it,
you know,
always? I don't think it's every hotel chain.
I've never been to a hotel that hasn't had one.
Well, I don't look that hard, but they're certainly in lots of hotels.
There's always a Bible in those drawers in the hotels. And there's a label that you can get that...
brought to you by the Gideons.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, brought to you by the Gideons. And there's a label that you can get, who I don't know who it's brought to you by, but you can print out these labels and it says warning. It's like a big red, you know, big red label that says warning. This is a work of fiction. Do not take it literally. Content advisory contains verses descriptive or of or advocating suicide, incest, bestiality, sadomasochism, mm-hmm. sexual activity in a violent context, murder, morbid violence, use of drugs or alcohol, homosexuality, voyeurism, revenge, undermining of authority figures, lawlessness, and human rights violations and atrocities. Exposure warning. Exposure to contents for extended periods of time or during formative years in children may cause delusions, hallucinations, decreased cognitive and objective reasoning abilities, and in extreme cases, pathological disorders, hatred, bigotry, and violence, including but not limited to fanaticism, murder, and genocide. And the idea is to print out these labels and slap them on the cover of the Bible.
Got it.
I think that's pretty funny. So the question is...
So the question is, what do you think of that?
Well, I think that, as a renter, and that's what you're doing, you're renting the hotel for the evening, and as a renter, you have certain sort of, I think you have expectations that that are reasonable, and that that you're not going to be subjected to other people's religious beliefs might be one of them. So I think that when you choose to leave your religious text in hotel rooms around the country, that you're probably it's a reasonable thing at that point that that people who have paid for those hotel rooms may toss them in the garbage.
I want to come back to this here in a moment. Let's go to Mike. He's in Raleigh listening to Talk Radio 850. Mike, you're on the air on Free Talk Live.
Yeah, I just wanted to give you an opinion and a comment.
Great.
I've been listening to your program now for about 20 minutes, and I just want to tell you how disappointed I am in the content and context of your show. I think you would do yourselves both well to have someone who's close to you to monitor your show and give you an honest opinion of how they think you conduct yourselves on this show.
Can you be more specific? What is it that is so offensive to you?
Well, I don't think, first of all, that you're into the content of a lot of the topics that you're discussing well enough to properly and respectfully discuss them. And I think your antics back and forth between you and the other person.
There's three people here. But can you give me a more specific example? Like, what issue do you feel like we're not, knowledgeable enough about, or what you're saying there? Go ahead.
Well, you know, I think what you need to do is have someone that is close to each of you, all three of you, listen to this program and critique the way you speak, the way you conduct the interviews, and the way you highlight.
It's just this show, or is it every episode?
Well, I've only listened to your show one. Well, no, I've actually heard parts of your show once or twice previously and was not impressed either time that I listened to your show.
Well,
your topics.
The difficulty I have here, like we have consultants that listen to the show and give us critique, and the difficulty is that oftentimes when people disagree with us, it's a lot easier for them to say, since we're younger than most talk show hosts, it's easier for them to say, you know, you're Bush League, you'll never amount to anything, you guys should give this up. But we've been doing it for 12 years, and we're on 100.
He's not saying anything. Oh, he's really not saying. You haven't given a specific critique yet,
he
Mike.
He says that we're all not good enough.
All you've said was you want someone to sit in the. By the way, there is someone sitting in the studio listening to us, but you want someone who's close to us to tell us what's wrong, but you won't tell us what you're finding so wrong about the show. Can you put it into words?
Well, I'm trying to, but it's difficult for me to say it because I don't want to be too awfully rude.
Oh, don't worry. We can handle rude people. It's no problem. I won't be offended.
First of all, I know that it's all about entertainment. You're not really interested in discussing, I don't think, the real value and content and purpose of any real issues. I think you're just interested in bantering.
So you don't think free speech is a real issue? You don't think property rights is a real issue?
I don't think the way you're handling it and treating it as a bona fide topic is respectful.
Which topic are you referring to?
Well, it's not respectful.
Hold on. Which topic are you referring to? We've talked about several so far in the show tonight.
Well, Hold on, first a minute. We're on my time now, and I'm not going to argue with you. This isn't an argument.
I'm asking you a question. I'm trying to understand what it is you're telling me. If you're trying to give me feedback, I need to understand the words coming out of your mouth. You mentioned some sort of topic that you felt like we weren't into. Which of the topics we've discussed have you felt that that was true, or do you just think it's everything that has come out of our mouths?
Well, almost everything, but I would say in particular the comments about the statue. And that, and I hope that listener, that caller still listening, who made that unbelievably rude and crude comment and joke about the statue. And first of all, for you not to have responded in some professional, responsive, and respectful way to have diminished his comment,
I think it sounds like you really just don't like people disagreeing with your religion, is what it sounds like.
Well, let me say this, and then I'm going to go.
Yes, sir.
Each of you, all three of you, if your show is taped, do you ever go home and listen to the way you interact back and forth?
Yes.
And to me, I guess if you've been doing it for 12 years and you're paid to do this, somebody must find it acceptable.
Believe it or not, people like different things in the world, right?
Yeah.
Like,
and so conflict, some people... conflict is the lifeblood of radio.
Well, let me say this, and then I'll let you go so you can have some other callers call in. I think you need to listen to yourselves again and see if you can improve your program.
Thanks for the call, Mike. I appreciate it, man.
This would be easily described as iconoclastic. Look that word up.
Yeah. If somebody calls and tells a good joke, I'm going to laugh at it. And I don't know what it means to be respectful or whatever. I mean, a good joke's a good joke. You know?
Somebody's going to cut that clip out. Ian saying, I don't know what it means to be respectful or whatever.
Look, this isn't your typical talk radio program. I mean, this guy is probably listening to, he's there in Raleigh listening to Talk Radio 850. We're probably the newest show on that particular radio station. They just added us probably about a month ago now, maybe 5 weeks ago. And
in the Bible Belt,
your typical talk radio station is going to have the Rush Limbaughs and the Sean Hannitys. And I don't have their schedule in front of me right now, but I can pull it up.
Not all the ideas deserve to be respected.
Yeah, but the idea of free speech is important. And you got to consider that speech that you disagree with is the kind of speech that needs to be protected.
And we're into that idea. Obviously, we're doing talk radio, so we should support free speech, right? More coming up here on Free Talk Live. Tell us how you feel.
I want to share something important that will not only improve your life, but the lives of many others as well. And all you need to do is drink coffee. I'm not talking about harmful store-bought or chain coffee. No, this is truly the best of the best coffee. We've partnered with Camano Island Coffee Roasters to offer BuzzBox. With every purchase, 10% goes towards our efforts to give the gift of human freedom by providing at least 100 microfinance loans via World Vision. So literally, just one cup at a time, you're having an impact and helping make a difference in the world. And one sip will have you buzzing to family and friends. To prove just how good it is, we're giving a free pound of coffee to everyone in the audience. All you do is cover shipping. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com. BuzzBox coffee is organic, so it contains no pesticides or toxins. It's shade grown, so less acidity and no heartburn. It's top 1% Arabica grade and gives people the opportunity to own their own coffee farms. Join us in making a huge impact at coffee.freetalklive.com.
Gold. It's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, Rich Paul is our first announced keynote speaker, and more are being announced now at keenvention.info. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. You can pre-order your tickets now for just $60 at keenvention.info, or you can pay with Bitcoin. Visit keenvention.info for more information and to lock in your tickets at the pre-order $60 price for the whole weekend. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at lrn.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. We'll take your calls about whatever's on your mind. We've been talking about freedom of speech, property rights here tonight. The last call seems to think we don't care about these issues.
Well, you know, and he has a point. There is a point that's there that I respect of his points, even if I don't respect religion. And the point is that I do get worried often. You know, the last time I was on, Free Talk Live lost an affiliate due to discussion about religion, and I always get concerned because I don't respect religion in any way. I have zero respect for the willful choice to abandon one's sense of reason, which is what I feel religion is.
I have religion, and I feel like I'm fairly reasonable.
Well, and I think that at any time you have to take something on faith, that you've decided mm-hmm. to abandon your reason.
Well, I don't know if I take it on faith.
Well,
I have a personal belief, and I believe I have evidence for that belief. But it's personal, so, you know, I can't right. quantify it scientifically for you.
Yeah, there's no scientific quantification. There's no proof. There's not even an attempt in most cases.
I've definitely had spiritual experiences while on certain substances.
Certain substances, absolutely.
So
mushrooms cause religion.
the atheism on the radio and television has a long and storied career. And I used to listen to Neil Bortz, who was a libertarian talk show host, even into the aughts and a little further than that. And, you know,
that man has a high respect for the Islamic religion.
No, he has no respect at all for the Islamic religion. And the one thing that, you know, I thought that was the one thing I always thought was that he's really just sort of taking the social momentum in the United States of Christianity and giving it elevation over the momentum of the religion of Islam in the Middle East. And I think that that's ethnocentrism, in my opinion. So I think that whatever your belief of people in the sky is your belief, and that's fine, but don't expect me to I don't expect you to respect mine, and you should not expect me to respect yours. But this is what they would do all the time to Neil Bortz in Atlanta, and he had stations all across the South, too, is they would, you know, they'd like, I agree with most of the things you're saying, Neil, but, and then I'm never going to listen to you again, right? Like, then it would be that thing, and he'd be like, oh, yeah, another person not listening. And the fact is that conflict is good on the radio. The conflict is good for people. People with different opinions challenge your mindset. Mm-hmm.
Aren't you kind of a hypocrite, though? Because you can criticize me for taking James in Arizona's calls because you don't want to talk to him because he's a challenging caller.
No, he's abusive.
Well, it's just because he says things you don't
he's
like?
He's threatening. No,
he hasn't threatened you. He beats around the bush.
He beats around the bush on threatening. I don't need that in my life. I don't need somebody who's angry all the time and abusive and threatening.
Well, I'll still take James' calls because this is an open phone show.
I'd talk to him.
This is an open phone show where anyone can call in, and there are very few rules on that.
Reward a-holes, you'll get a-holes.
James, you're on Free Talk Live.
Well, speaking of a-holes, thanks for taking me on, Minister Freeman. I grieve for the innocent children and women that were droned to death during what Mark Edgington called a legitimate terrorist attack on the Pentagon. There were women and children in that plane that flew into the Pentagon.
I don't think he called it legitimate. What are you talking about? What does that even mean?
He absolutely positively did call it legitimate terrorist attack on another day on another show of Free Talk Live.
All right, I'll have to take your word for it because Mark apparently won't bother responding.
I don't lie. You can take my word for it, that's for sure. You can take my word for it. Ian, every time I call into Free Talk Live, I don't lie or disparage anybody unless they have it coming. May I continue?
Go right ahead.
Speaking of, the modern-day jihadist terrorists that are waging a warpath across the Levant, Ian, that have murdered and raped and destroyed Sunni and mosque or Shiite mosques, even their competitors in Iraq, they have yet to confront one American soldier, but how anybody like Minister Edgington can say we created them is an offense to me and anybody that has any morals or religious.
I didn't create anybody, and I thank you for the call tonight and the opinion at 855-450-FREE. I think what you
so
what
when he's
might
suggesting
have meant,
that we created them, is he talking about the fact that like people might react to their families being bombed since the 60s
I think he was,
and their children being blown to bits in front of them, that they might retaliate and attack America? Is that what he means by creating them?
I think that's what he might have been getting at there.
I mean, I don't know if we literally created them, but I mean, I'm sure bombing people's families might have that reaction. I don't know if it's 100%, correlation is not causation, but...
Or you could point out the U.S. government has funded groups like Al-Qaeda and Saddam Hussein in the
right.
In the past.
Like how we're going to be training Syrians here, and then we'll be fighting them in a war in 10 years. We're not causing these things. I mean, obviously, we're not creating these terrorists by funding them and arming them.
Not funding anyone. I'd just like to remind you, and that's why
I use the we.
It's a real pet peeve of mine when people say we did this and we did that. Now, maybe James and Arizona would fund the military and have them go and kill people
in
his name.
I'm sure he would.
But I personally am not interested in funding killings, and nor am I interested in funding imprisoning peaceful people, and so I won't pay for it.
Yeah, I as far as I'm concerned, blowback is quite a well-documented reaction. And if you really think that people in the Middle East aren't reacting to the United States' foreign policy, you think they're dogs.
They
you
just hate us for our freedom, Mark. Right.
Well,
they hate us because of pop music and rock and roll.
You know how the United people in the U.S. would react if some foreign power decided to come over here and rule over us. It would be a guerrilla war to the very last of them.
When they weigh the issue, so they go, well, half of my family was just blown to bits, or, well, they in the United States, they just had these nude pictures, and it's all over the pop media because these celebrities are exposed by nude. Well, that just makes me so much more mad. My family being blown to bits is the minor issue. Yeah. These Americans need to be stopped because there's naked pictures of celebrities on the internet. They are just despicable people, these Americans. I mean, really, like, why? I still don't understand how ill-informed people are just able to just walk around with this, like, just, well, I hate us for our freedom. I'm just completely ignorant of everything in the world. You know, like, how do people in such a cloud of ignorance?
For one thing, they think that U.S. foreign policy started on September the 11th, 2001. Mm,
right.
You know, that nothing occurred, that there wasn't 5 decades worth of U.S. intervention in the Middle East up to that point. And,
nothing precipitated the attacks. things. Just out of the blue.
The quotes.
How'd that happen?
I'm looking at a page of quotes here from Osama bin Laden, him talking about his upset with the U.S.'s governments being all cozy with the Saudi Arabian government.
Hey, drewsdefense.org is where you can go to donate to Andrew Jones. He's facing the rest of his life in prison for being allegedly one of the operators of the Silk Road, which is an underground marketplace. He's also a Free State Project participant, and he can use folks' help raising money to put on his defense. If you think the war on drugs needs to end, you're willing to do something to help out, please go to drewsdefense.org and help out Andrew Jones. He could really use the assistance. PayPal, Bitcoin, drewsdefense.org. That's drewsdefense.org. We're going to come back with more Free Talk Live. We still have to get to the rest of the question about the labeling of the Bibles.
Right.
I want to come back to that discussion. Your calls are welcome as well at 855-450-FREE.
Healthy elimination is essential to high energy, a cheerful mood, and prevention of disease. Some of the founders of our modern holistic health thinking state that disease begins in a toxic colon. A toxic intestinal tract is the foundation for virtually all degenerative disease, and a clean and well-moving intestinal tract is the foundation of health.
I just want to say that you folks have an amazing product. I've taken whey protein products for years, and I've never noticed the results I have with your product. I've suffered with thoughts of constipation most of my life. Within a few days of taking One World Whey, I noticed a dramatic change. Also, in the past few years, I've experienced symptoms associated with diabetes. I feel horrible when I've had too much sugar, and I've been getting the foot pain as well. But I've noticed in the past week or so, I'm not feeling bad anymore, and the foot pain is gone. I'm just finishing up the 5-pound tub I ordered and just got off the phone ordering more. I love your product. Thank you.
Call 888-988-3325. That's 888-988-3325. Or visit oneworldway.com. That's oneworld, W-H-E-Y.com.
A new teen trend of walking wet and nude couldn't have caught on at a worse time, and a taxpayer is outraged. And lo, the Lord said unto the Israelites, look unto the heavens, and you shall see a news review program to rival the greatest wonders of the earth. This is The Onion Week in Review. As a front of dense, frigid air and snow showers brought sub-zero temperatures to much of the country this week, Canton, Ohio residents noted that the blanketing of snow they had received created the illusion that their town was not a total shithole. Residents added that unlike its typical depressing reality, the snow-cloaked town actually looked halfway livable.
Canton is usually a miserable little dump, but you know when that first snow fell and like covered everything in a layer of white powder? For about 5 minutes, it was like not everything I saw depressed the living out of me.
Reports from locals also confirmed that for a brief period, the streets, parks, and buildings around them gave the surprising impression of not being a rundown, heartbreaking excuse for a hometown.
This is the Onion News Network.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kit Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kitessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com. What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, dial toll-free and bring up anything you want here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online at freetalklive.com. Please enjoy the features waiting for you there, and they're all totally free. Again, that's freetalklive.com. Do you need focus and are feeling fatigued, trying to get that extra edge when it counts? Look into modafinil from modup.net. Businessmen around the world are talking about modafinil from modup.net and how it's making the difference in their work and giving them the critical edge they need. Plus, students are using modafinil. In fact, 1 in 5 of them are using this cognitive enhancer, offering multiple benefits, including a double-digit increase in short-term memory, fighting off fatigue, and greater focus overall, so you can get things done. Over at modup.net, they make it affordable for everyone to take advantage of the benefits of modafinil by being 80 to 85% lower in price than the brand name. But don't mistake low prices for inferior quality. They ensure that purity and potency are consistent to that of the branded version. Remember, Free Talk Live is an international radio show, and modup.net ships worldwide. It is your responsibility to know if local prescription requirements and laws apply. Modup.net also gives you a deep discount. If you pay with Bitcoin, you'll save 33%. Plus, to make the deal even better, use code FTL, and you'll get 10 free tablets with your order. Again, code FTL at modup.net. It's world-class service at a great price for modafinil. That's modup.net with code FTL as we go to the phones and your calls and thoughts. We got to come back to the Bible labeling thing. Don't let me forget that. Let's go first to Scott, however. He's listening to WPTK in Raleigh, Talk Radio 850.
So I've been listening this evening and for a couple of weeks now, and you made a few comments. One was about, you know, Raleigh and that right-wing Christian mantra that's getting beat up a little bit.
I said Bible Belt, didn't I?
Yeah, it's good enough for me. I mean, I'm an Israeli citizen living in the United States. I have two children. One's 30. She's very intelligent. She's a scientist. The other one's 14. They have different mothers. I'm never married to either one of them. And the Christians beat me up constantly. So I enjoy it. I tell them all the time, you beat up Jesus, you know, mine's beating me up too. So I'm a Philistine. I was born in Haifa. English is a second language. I speak Spanish fluently. I speak Arabic and Hebrew. I understand the politics of the day. And these Christians are just insulted because they're naive and they're getting their clocks cleaned. And it's just the real radical right wingers who are just as, you know, they're not violent, but they're, you said it earlier, when they tell you you're not going to heaven or the hereafter because you haven't accepted Christ as your savior, or you've done something to defile a statue, or my daughter, who's a tenured teacher at a renowned university, has tattoos. I mean, for Pete's sake, she's creating things that save human lives in the medical industry. And so she's going to hell. Okay, great. You know, have
she's going to hell because she has tattoos?
According to these right-wingers.
Oh, yeah, that's right. It's your body's a temple thing, right?
Well, that's Leviticus 19. Or I don't know what they call it in that weird Jewy book.
It's an unnatural mark. It's a whole thing. But, you know, then you confront these people. And, again, I'm a biblical scholar. I could give it to you verbatim. And I confront these people, and I talk to them, and I say, gee, you're an idiot. Your kids are pushing away from you. You're condemning people because of your naivete. You're not tolerant. You should turn a blind eye. When my daughter came to me and said she got a tattoo, I said, cool. She said, you're not upset? I said, no. She's like, okay. If she came to me and told me she was a lesbian, I would say, cool.
Yeah.
I don't care. You know, enjoy yourself, sweetheart. But anyway, you guys are a breath of fresh air. to the right-wing thumping, I beat them up. I would have, because it's September 11th, my brother lives in New York City. He spent 3 days on the pile. He works for Housing Preservation and Development. My sister-in-law is a Jamaican immigrant, and she's a cop in New York City. So we're intimate with the situation. I would have turned the Saudi Peninsula into green glass the next day. Now, okay, that's a bit violent, and maybe it was uncalled for. But nonetheless, we're talking about Shia and Sunni, and we leave out the Wahhabist pricks. The Wahhabis in Saudi Arabia are a bunch of clandestine retards. I have no problem standing up to them. They defile women on a daily basis. Their human rights violations are as thick as the Bible in seven languages.
I thought Wahhabists were Shiites with like just a sect of Shia.
Yeah, yeah, and they have Sharia law, and if you misbehave, they beat the ever-loving life out of you, or they kill you. There's
so,
no news
Scott,
coming out.
Not unusual, yeah.
I understand that you're frustrated by, you know, the Wahhabists, etc., and that you at one time wanted to turn something into glass. And I don't support violence as a solution to problems, but if someone does support violence, then they should be free, in my mind, to hire any mercenaries they want to go over and persecute whatever kind of violence that they're interested in doing.
Agreed.
And then that way you would have to accept whatever consequences would come from that as the person hiring the killers, whereas I don't want to be involved at all. I don't want to have any of my money going towards killing around the world. And can you respect that?
Scott's down.
Would you be all right with respecting that? About me.
Absolutely. So I got a letter from City Securities, which I hold a portfolio with for maybe 20 years. I'm almost 50 years old. And they sold their shares of their company. They sold City Securities, Buffalo, New York, where I played ice hockey in college, and I made some investments with some of my friends. Well, anyway, they sold to Wells Fargo. I sold every single one of my shares because Wells Fargo is wholly owned by the Saudi government. Hmm. It's ridiculous that people don't know this. They're the largest mortgage banker in the United States today. They hold more secondary car loans. So you just said something that I'm very passionate about. I'm not giving those pricks any of my money. Zero.
Scott, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. I'm glad you're enjoying the show, and thank you for the call tonight. And that's just great. That was a great counterpoint to the guy who called earlier. He was like, this is the worst show. Paraphrasing him. This, you guys are terrible. You need a consultant, etc. Whatever.
Well, you know, there's been many studies done on biblical literacy.
My point being, you can't please everybody.
Sure,
you just
sure.
can't.
There's been many studies done on biblical literacy, and it's funny that, you know, he's like talking about, I can cite it to you verbatim. And it's just funny because it's like, the people who know the Bible best, there's a saying that's like, you want to stop believing the Bible, read it. you know, the people who are most well versed in the Bible, they've done studies like Pew Research and what's the other big one?
Rasmussen
polls, and there's another big polling companies, and they've gone and they've asked questions and done Bible tests to find out who's the most biblically literate. The number one group of people who are most
atheists.
Biblically literate, atheists. Second most, Jews, and then third most, agnostics.
There you go.
And it's just like, you know, none of these groups are Christian, and they know the Bible better.
It's not a surprise at all. Now, look, earlier,
well,
Johnson,
I'm not going to call all Christians ignorant, but I mean, I think that one of the...
No, that's not fair.
I'm not saying that, but what I am going to say, and I think that Christians probably can resonate if they listen to me for a second, is that the religion, the way it has evolved up to this point, and I think that anybody would be crazy to say that Christianity hasn't evolved since the first century. So it has evolved to the point that, A, you're threatened with hell. B, you're rewarded with heaven. The Baptists, I'm just going to use them as an interesting point here, is that all they believe is all you have to do is once saved, always saved. You give your heart to Jesus, you're saved. Now, that's a pretty low cost. You do something wrong, you should probably ask for forgiveness, but ultimately you're saved if you're washed in the blood of Jesus Christ. So, small cost. Terrible, consequence for not doing it, which is going to being tortured for all eternity in hell. Now, you've got this weird situation set up where people are like, yeah, well, might as well do that. And then you get this large membership of people. It's supposed to be the narrow way that is difficult for people to go, but it's not. I mean, you know, here I sit. I have asked Jesus into my heart before.
Well, wait a minute. Well, hold on. It is the narrow way to do what Jesus is actually suggesting, right? To be of peace and to
forgive. I don't know that Jesus existed, man.
And to forgive. Okay, fine. Buddha. You know, all of these great men over all the years have had, you know, it's been a pretty tough path for them, and the path that was supposedly advocated by Jesus to love one's enemies. I mean, that's not an easy road to forgive people. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. You can share your thoughts with us here on Free Talk Live.
At the Home Depot, buy one or more pallets of GAF Royal Sovereign 3-tab shingles and save up to 20%. Let's raise the roof, but lower the cost with bulk pricing on GAF, America's number one shingle, featuring advanced protection technology. This is worth shouting from the rooftops. Let's do this. Up to 20% off one or more pallets of select GAF shingles. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. Valid through September 17th, U.S. only. See store for details.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Summertime is save big time at Herbal Healer Academy. Long-term customers know summer is the time to stock up at herbalhealer.com. And for new customers, welcome to the web's best place to save on vitamins, minerals, and more. Log on for summer specials, including all sizes of colloidal silver, colloidal minerals, and intestinal freedom on sale. Choose from Herbal Healer's great variety of weight loss products like apple cider vinegar, Hoodia, and Metabolic Complex and Pro-Metabolic, all on sale now. Also, the anti-parasite Intestinal Freedom and Wormwood Plus Complex, plus Stevia Liquid Sweetener and the Super Enzymes, all on sale for summer at herbalhealer.com. As always, we offer certificate correspondence courses in natural medicine. Enjoy same-day shipping and free online newsletter. Log on now to herbalhealer.com and look for summer specials to save big with our nation's leader in supplying quality natural medicine and education since 1988. Herbal Healer Academy.
This is novelist Tom Robbins. When my mother was diagnosed with glaucoma, her conservative Virginia physician told her there was only one treatment that might ease her pain and save her eyesight. That treatment was medical marijuana, which he could not prescribe. I offered to get her some and teach her how to use it effectively, but my father objected because marijuana was against the law. So my mother, who loved to read and walk in nature, was condemned to grow cruelly, unnecessarily blind. Tragedies like this happen all the time, but they don't have to keep happening. To learn more about medical marijuana, call the Marijuana Policy Project at 1-877-JOIN-MPP or visit them on the web at mpp.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateurs, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
You bring up whatever you want here on Free Talk Live. You can lambast us. You can insult us. You can do whatever you want here. Mark gets his feelings hurt sometimes about it.
Oh, though. I get my feelings hurt.
The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and you can join us on Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. Just send a contact request over Skype. It will be approved. and it is that easy. Free Talk Live brought to you by Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. If you haven't seen it yet, it's not too late. It's free online forever. You can go to victimlesscrimespree.com. Victimless Crime Spree has been, selected, if you will, by the brilliant algorithms of Google as the most relevant piece of information relating to the search victimless crime, as I understand it. And
what about just victimless?
It's up there, I think. I don't know where it shows up on there. But if you do one of those, you open up a private browser window and you go to Google and you type those things in, you should have really good results with it. You have to be careful when you're getting Google results from, just typing things in and
Google knows you.
Right. Trying to figure out if that's where it shows up for everyone. Like if I Google something that's related to Keen, Free Keen may show up at the top of the list. But that's because I go there a lot and they know that. So
it does not come up for me under either a logged in browser session or
really it's not coming
private.
Up anymore
it's well, coming it up as the Wikipedia entry.
It was for a little while. I'm sorry about that. Try YouTube and then it might come up there.
I'm sure it'll come up on YouTube.
So YouTube has selected Victimless Crime Spree as the most relevant piece of pop culture relating to that particular search. It's a great movie. It's an hour and a half long documentary film which focuses on our friend Derek J and co-host Derek J from the Monday night version of the show.
Definitely does come up.
And the five arrests that he experienced in a one-year period of time for victimless crimes where no one was harmed. And you can go and you can enjoy the film and share it with your friends over at victimlesscrimespree.com or just search for victimless crime. In fact, I think you can just do victimless on YouTube and it will come up as as the first result. So we're going to go to your phone calls and thoughts here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's go to, we've got Eric in Raleigh listening to Talk Radio 850. Eric, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, how you guys doing?
Hey, Eric, what's on your mind tonight?
I just wanted to call in and give my support for, I'm in the Raleigh area, and, your show is definitely something good that we need around here, because you are certainly right on what our regular radio is, and it's really just been a pleasure to listen to you guys, so I just wanted to chip in my support.
Well, right on. You know what you can do better than that, better than calling in? Cause, I mean, it's nice to hear from the choir, so to speak, the people that enjoy the show, and I appreciate that. I don't want it to sound like I don't appreciate it. But the best thing you could do would be to contact Talk Radio 850 when you get a chance and tell Brian Freeman there, the program director, tell him thanks.
His last name is Freeman?
Believe it or not, yeah. Awesome. Yeah, no relation. But super nice guy.
Considering your name is made up.
Yeah. Well, I don't know if he made his name up either.
I don't know what he's done.
And by the way, everybody made up their name at some damn point, right?
No. Not everybody had made up their... You're suggesting I'm my ancestors? What kind of nut are you?
What?
Everybody made up their name?
Yeah, somebody at some point along the line made up the last name Edge.
Yeah.
Right. But somebody made it up. So what?
My last name is Edgington.
Okay, and somebody made up Edgington at some
point. But
you said
everybody did, and I didn't make up
I'm
the
sorry,
name Edgington.
I didn't mean everybody as in, like, you made it up. But at some point, your name was made up in the past. So just because I made up a name doesn't make it less valid than your made-up name either. Anyway, the best thing to do, Eric, would be to contact Talk Radio 850. And the same thing's true for all listeners out there. If you hate us, go ahead and contact them, too, and let them know how much you hate us.
Don't worry, they will.
The haters definitely call. And that's the thing. The people who hate certain shows are far more likely to call the program director and bitch and moan about it than the people who actually appreciate a show. So it never hurts to give a little bit of positive feedback for the stuff you like on the station. You know what I mean?
I definitely hear you.
Thanks, Eric, for your call tonight. Anything else you want to throw out there?
Nope, I'm good.
Appreciate the call tonight.
I like to think that when Ian was making up his name, that he was trying to instill in himself the best characteristics of both Morgan Freeman and Gordon Freeman from the Half-Life games.
Nah, they weren't influential at all. It's more of a statement about who
Maybe
I
Maybe Abby Freeman?
Don't know who that is. But it's more of a statement about who I prefer to be rather than who I was named at birth. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Rusty. He's in Houston.
Ian
You're on Free Talk Live.
Howdy, y'all. First, I want to start off with, I believe one of the co-hosts said, does respect religion. Just wanted to say kudos to you, buddy. If she was on the other foot, I guarantee they don't respect you. And that's kind of one of the reasons I'm calling is I think the religious right is slowly destroying the Republican Party, especially in my area. I've had it where precinct chairs, candidates have tried to apply for a vacant precinct and they're gay. And there's a huge drawn out fight about it. Hmm. And that the gentleman, that's the only reason that they aren't going to become a precinct chair or allowed to be involved in the party is because they're openly homosexual.
Wow.
And I'm a member of Lockout Republicans and things of that nature. And I went up to one of them and I was like, oh, hey, you know, I'm an atheist. And he was like, okay, don't worry about it. I'll be quiet about it. Because their perception is they hate us more than they hate the gay people. So
yeah, it could be. I don't know. That's a good question. Who do the standard run-of-the-mill Republicans hate more, gays or atheists?
Atheists are the most hated group in America.
Is that right?
Yeah.
But by Republicans, though.
Well, if they're the most hated group in America, it probably stands to reason.
Probably
also most hated.
Well, wait until the gay Satanist rolls in, and I'm sure that they'll like they'll be siding with the atheist. Yes, I think that the Republicans have they've got some messages that will work, that will resonate with people. The problem is they're mired down in social conservatism that just ruins it all. I'm a Republican delegate to the state convention. I've got as much room to talk about this as anybody.
Rusty, yeah, any other thoughts?
One passing thought here about the statue incident. You know, back in, we had this thing called Night of Lights around Christmas where I grew up. And people had those little deer light statues. And, you know, they invite people to go through their lawns and look at the neighborhood. And sometimes teenagers would go out there and put the deer, lights up to where it looks like they're trying to mate.
Oh,
and,
sure.
You know, if a cop caught him, they were just like, you know, don't do that. Or the person who had the deer said, I don't appreciate you coming on my property anymore. And that was the end of it.
Really as it should be. I mean, it's detail. That's
exactly.
You could argue that that's more offensive than what happened with the Jesus statue. By the way, for listeners that don't know what we're talking about earlier in the show tonight, there was an issue with a teenager who's facing prison time over a picture of him with his crotch near a kneeling Jesus. And obviously some people are upset about that. But in relation to, what should happen to him, I don't think there should be any sort of punishment. He didn't damage anything. At least you could argue with the deer that someone plucked it from the yard and it had to be placed back, you know, that there was some level of effort involved in fixing that problem. But, I mean, if that's the worst thing that happens to your Christmas display, I think you're doing all right. And thank you for the call tonight, Rusty. I appreciate it.
There's a Wikipedia entry specifically for baby Jesus theft.
There's a lot of it, too.
Yeah, that does happen a lot. The toll-free number tonight is 855.
And you don't support that, right?
Of course not. That's theft.
Right.
Why would I support? Why did you even have to ask that question?
Just making it clear for folks.
The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So,
there's defacement. That stuff happens all the time. Is that a veteran?
Yeah, that's
object?
Not okay.
Yeah, it's not okay. No, it's not okay. But what I'm saying is that it happens all the time, and that the punishment. It's like, why is this case so special with this guy who took a photograph and didn't damage anything?
Right. Would he have to go to if he had tagged the side of a building with graffiti? Mm-hmm. Would he go to prison for 2 years? Would he be facing
it's
a charge
warm.
Like that?
In the area, there's another show on the Liberty Radio Network I was listening to earlier, mm-hmm. Angel Clark, and she had done some research into this and found out that in the area where he's at, the punishment for graffiti... actually damaging property in that area is 1 year mm-hmm. in jail, yeah. Whereas it's 2 years.
If you offend someone.
Right.
Ridiculous.
Well, okay, so I agree with you that 2 years is crazy, and I don't think this kid's going to get 2 years. I don't think it would benefit anybody if
hold
this
that thought, Mark. We have a self-described Bible thumper on the line. William is in Raleigh listening to Talk Radio 850. Hello, William, you're on Free Talk Live.
Wow, you're going to interrupt him for me, huh? Okay, hold that thought. William wants to talk.
And here you are.
I just wanted to make a plea here. If people want to call in, they don't like Christianity and everything. I mean, I would like to just get away from all of the false accusations and the insults that are only for the purpose of an insult. If I give you something and it insults you, but I wasn't trying to insult it, you, in other words, whenever we say the choice is set before you to accept Christ or to not accept Christ.
Hang on, William. I'm going to bring you back for this conversation here in a moment because I've not said I have a problem with Christians. I haven't said that. Johnson, he's pretty rough towards...
I have a problem with religion itself, not with Christians,
right.
People.
I don't have a problem with religion.
I just have a problem with the belief in hell.
I don't like organized religion, personally. Religion, I don't have a problem with. I actually respect people who seek that. More coming up.
Oh,
fall, a time for cooler temperatures and hot deals from America's Best Value Inn. Save 15% when you book a room online at americasbestvalueinn.com and stay now through October 23rd. Plus, you'll enjoy free continental breakfast, internet, and instant rewards through our Value Club at most of our 1,000 hotels in North America. Fall into savings this season at America's Best Value Inn.
Gabino lives in Palcapata, Peru. He buys old appliances like irons, radios, and TV sets, fixes them up, and resells them. He saw an opportunity to expand his business and needed a loan to buy more appliances. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan, and the expansion was a success. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Thursday, September 11th, 2014. Gold opened today at $1,243, silver opened at $18.75, and Bitcoin is trading around $473.69. Support for Liberty Beat comes from SovereignMiners.com. Interested in mining Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies? Sovereign Miners has you covered. All purchases come with a free script ASIC miner. Visit SovereignMiners.com to buy your miner today. And support comes from the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. Vote Michael Cargill to get the cars moving. Learn more or sign up to volunteer at CargillForTexas.com. Political advertisement paid for by the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. On the eve of the 13th anniversary of the 9/11 attacks, President Obama announced his plan to degrade and ultimately destroy the Islamic State. The president said the plan will include continued airstrikes, counterterrorism actions, support from allied nations, and military training and assistance for rebels in Iraq and Syria. Obama asked for support from the House and the Senate to show the world the U.S. was united against ISIS. Protesters with the Justice for Michael Brown Leadership Coalition temporarily blocked Interstate 70 near Ferguson, Missouri, on the one-month anniversary of Michael Brown's death. The act of civil disobedience was done to ensure Ferguson is not forgotten, the organizers said. Several arrests were made as a heavy police presence arrived. Authorities brought out the LRAD sound cannon for what they say was a safety precaution. The civil disobedience followed a busy city council meeting on Tuesday night, where hundreds of outraged Ferguson residents expressed their anger. Several changes were announced by the city council, including plans to create a citizens review board for the police department. The 8th Annual Farm and Food Leadership Conference will take place Monday, September 15th and Tuesday, September 16th in Bastrop, Texas. Catch up on the latest legislative and regulatory news regarding our food supply and leave with the tools needed to make a difference. The keynote speaker will be Jim Hightower, national radio commentator, writer, public speaker, and author of the book, Swim Against the Current. Even a dead fish can go with the flow. Lunch will be provided both days from local foods prepared by Chef Sonia Cote of Hillside Pharmacy in Eden East. For more info, including a full list of conference topics and speakers, visit farmandranchfreedom.org. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from My Magic Mud, all-natural teeth whitener. Go to MyMagicMud.com to hear a short interview with Dr. Griffin Cole. That's MyMagicMud.com. And today's edition of the Liberty Beat is brought to you by Brave New Books, your source for all things Bitcoin. Now hosting a Bitcoin ATM, located in Austin, Texas at 1904 Guadalupe Street, or online at bravenewbookstore.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, September 11, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com and like us on Facebook at facebook.com/thelibertybeat. A Pennsylvania teenager is facing criminal charges after posting pictures to Facebook of him simulating a sex act with a statue of Jesus. KRON 4 News reports the teen posted that he took the pictures in late July at the statue of a kneeling Jesus in front of the Love in the Name of Christ Christian organization in his hometown of Everett. The criminal charge, which will be heard in family court, consists of desecration of a venerated object. Pennsylvania law defines desecration as defacing, damaging, polluting, or otherwise physically mistreating in a way that the actor knows will outrage the sensibilities of persons likely to observe or discover the action. The teen, whose name has not been released, could face up to 2 years in a juvenile jail if convicted. An international human rights group says Israel committed war crimes in the latest round of fighting against Hamas in Gaza. The Associated Press reports that New York-based Human Rights Watch made the conclusion following an investigation it carried out into attacks on or near three UN-run schools housing displaced Palestinians. The group said Thursday that no military targets were apparent in the school area and that some of the attacks were indiscriminate. The Israeli military had no immediate comment. On Wednesday, it announced it launched its own probe into the war. Israel accuses Hamas of using civilians as human shields. A plan is underway by Ecuadorian President Rafael Correa to begin taxing fast food restaurants and using the funds for health awareness campaigns. The so-called junk food tax would focus on international fast food chains, but did not specify when the tax might begin. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries, homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. And support comes from Roberts & Roberts Brokers Incorporated, specializing in precious metals since 1977. Now accepting Bitcoin, online, rrbi.co, or by phone, 800-874-9760. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, September 11th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting.
Zoo visitors watch the mating rituals of the ice cream shop staff, and a serious coworker puts on headphones to focus on his sandwich. Happiness is perpetually fleeting, so try to savor the next few minutes before it disappears once again. This is the Onion Week in Review. FBI officials announced they just can't bring themselves to bust a man who recently downloaded every season of the 1990s television show Picket Fences from a BitTorrent website. While stressing that pirating copyrighted material is strictly illegal, federal authorities expressed their sympathy for the man and claimed that perhaps the story of Sheriff Jimmy Brock and the strange events in a small Wisconsin town is all he has left to cling to.
We have more than enough evidence to bust him for piracy, but if the poor guy really wants to watch all four seasons of a 20-year-old CBS drama that nobody remembers, he's clearly going through a pretty big rough patch right now. Frankly, we don't need to make it any worse.
For statistical purposes, we have seized all private data from your personal computer, and we are disgusted with your recent internet search history. You sick f***. For more, keep checking theonion.com.
Free Talk Live, toll-free number here, 855-453. That's 855-450-3733. As usual, we come to the table prepared to talk about various different things, and most of them we never get to.
And as usual, you know, Free Talk Live, it's Free Talk Live. You know, people call in.
Right. I do want to talk about the Islamic State plans of destruction that Barack Obama has, and maybe we'll get to that. But your calls come first. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Now, of course, you can bring up anything you want. You don't have to talk about the statue incident. For those of you just tuning in, a teenager in Pennsylvania is facing 2 years in prison for a photograph taken of him in a simulated sexual position with a crouching Jesus. So you can figure out what that position might be. And so that was an issue, and that led to a larger discussion about religion, because some people, who one guy in particular who called in tonight, he doesn't like the show. He doesn't like what he's been hearing. He's listened for 20 minutes, and he doesn't like it at all because we're not respectful enough, et cetera, et cetera. And certain people or ideas don't deserve that much respect. You have to earn respect in the world. And if you haven't earned it, why should I give it to you? Now, I think I generally do respect individuals by default until I'm given a reason not to. I won't treat someone rudely unless they give me a reason to. So like when the DEA was in town here in Keene raiding a local storefront, I was not very friendly to those DEA agents.
I did not appreciate the actions that they were taking. Earlier this week, there was a parking enforcer on Tuesday who was ticketing people on the streets in downtown Keene, and I happened to be there, and I started to save people from getting tickets by depositing coins in the expired meters, and the parking enforcer started to go berserk and started to change directions erratically, trying to throw me off my game or something like that. And ultimately, what she ended up doing was looking ridiculous.
She did seem very odd.
She changed directions 18 times in 2 minutes and made a video about that. And
but those direction changes were directly 180 degrees. So it's not like she,
yes.
She wasn't...
Oh, thank you for clarifying that. She's doing 180 degree changes, so she's literally walking back and forth on a short path.
This ought to confuse him.
Yeah.
Right, on a sidewalk, walking back and forth, I won't be able to follow this person.
Right, it's just crazy. And but I've taken flack for that because I wasn't nice enough to that lady. Look, I'm just out there trying to save people from getting parking tickets. It's not my fault if the woman who's supposed to be giving the parking tickets goes bat-ass crazy during that time, and I happen to have a video camera recording it. I think it's funny. I think that's funny. I think it's funny to laugh at the aggressors in life because they want to be taken so seriously, and they don't like it when you don't take them seriously. And I think we shouldn't take them seriously. I think we should laugh at them as much as possible, but only because of the things they do. Not poke fun at them because of what their name is or their skin color or anything like that, but because of the things they do and they say. Because those are ridiculous and absurd and outrageous enough, and I don't think there's a problem with laughing about that stuff. But we want to hear from you about whatever's on your mind. In fact, we had a self-described Bible thumper, William, in Raleigh, listening to Talk Radio 850. And William, right before the break, you really didn't have a chance to make much of a point, so I wanted to make sure you had a chance. Go ahead.
Basically, I wanted to give a brief outline because I know you had other people on there, and who wants to hear one person talk on that? Basically, the tenets of the Christian experience are, first off, you accept the blood covenant because we, being, you know, humans, we're not able to pay, you know, the sin debt. And
to pay then, what?
Sin debt. God created sin, right?
He's asking you, William.
I didn't mean that my knowledge is so vast that you can't blow me out of the water now, okay? I mean, get this. I know you're a little bit smarter than me, but honest.
I'm not claiming to be smarter. I used to be a Christian. As much of a Bible thumper as one could possibly be, you weren't. You were just a kid.
What?
You weren't a Bible thumper.
They baptized me. I went to Christian camp.
Does that make you a Bible thumper? You were a kid.
I wasn't a Bible thumper, but you don't have to be a Bible thumper to be a Christian.
That's the only point I was making. I said I was as much of a Bible thumper as one could be.
Okay.
And that's the I'm trying to create with William here.
I'm sorry, I was a Christian.
A sense of you know,
rapport.
Mm-hmm. And the point I'm trying to make is that look, I understand these ideas. I just at some point or another, I gave up, thinking that the Bible was the unerring word of God. That doesn't mean it's not some people's experience of God, because I think it is.
Well, but, I don't have a show that I can do what you're doing. You got a show. I mean, you can make accusations and ask questions all day. Let me get this real quick for you, and then you can just give me a brief, you know, I'll hang up and listen. But that's the first tenet. And the second is that, you have to live to be led of the Spirit, the Holy Spirit. And that's and what we use as an outline so that we can get the unction that the Spirit gives us, we have the Ten Commandments. And as we present that to you when we're having the conversation, it's not said as an insult. None of the stuff, yesterday and today, all I've heard is just one insult after another and people talking about how knowledgeable they are. Well, my doctor has more knowledge than me, but that don't mean he can change a flat. If I pass him,
that's absolutely true.
Over and help him,
Everybody's got different areas of knowledge. That's absolutely true. I agree with that.
Thank you. And we all are in this together, and we need to help each other.
Brother, I'm with you there. That sounds like a more Christian attitude to me. I'd like to say.
Well, one way that you won't do it is if you're beheading people because you're disappointed.
If you're beheading people?
I don't hear what you got. Yeah, well, I think you'll put that.
Are you bringing ISIS into this? I don't understand what that reference is all about.
Maybe it's not about much. Maybe it's for your edification, and then you reflect back to me where you're at with.
Are you saying that by beheading people, do you mean that we're biting off their heads verbally on the air? I don't know what you're getting at there.
Well, just any kind of acidic, just when you jump my ass because you don't like where I'm at with my thing here, then we got a problem. If you're beheading me, you know, with a guillotine, or if you're just absolutely making sure that you murderize me to the point
this
that
has gone off into a realm of metaphor that is beyond me, and I thank you for the call, William. You are an advanced user of metaphor in comparison to me. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. A little bit out of my realm. Anybody else care to comment on the beheading?
I don't know. I guess that one of the thought processes that I have is that I think that many groups, most groups, want to be considered the underdog, and that oftentimes people, you know, that are calling in, and I disagree with a lot of people that call in about, you know, their thoughts on Christianity, because there's two things about Christianity I don't accept, which is that the Bible is the unerring word of God and that hell exists. Mm. And there are lots of Christians that don't accept hell and lots of Christians that don't accept that the Bible is the unerring word of God. But if somebody takes that position, and yes, I admittedly am going to be on the air after they get off, so I have a position of power. But I don't think it's not throwing you to the lions.
Well, if you'd like your own talk radio show, you can always, you know, a lot of talk radio stations
put the time
will take
in.
Your money. I mean,
12 years.
Well, we put in 12 years to get to the point where we are, but if you want to go down to, you know, WPTK, I can't speak for them, but if you came in with $10,000, they probably would sell you some airtime. I mean, I don't know. I don't work there, so maybe they are one of the few remaining radio companies who won't sell their air, and that's a really respectable position to be in. But, you know, you can always go to the Clear Channel station or one of the other big corporate dogs, and they'll take your money. You can get your own show. Pay for play, as they call it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Look, I don't want to bite anybody's head off or decapitate anybody verbally or in real life, but it's certainly true that the issue of Christianity and what some Christians advocate can really upset people. And that certainly includes people who feel like they have been damaged in some way. And Mark, you're one of those people feeling like you've been damaged by this religious upbringing that you had.
I think I've got
bitter.
I think that I've got PTSD, and I think that it, I don't want that to feel bad for people who have like really terrible PTSD, but I was threatened with hell for many, many years. There, you know, but you do something bad, you're going to hell.
So so you think that the church deserves restitution because this kid defaced the statue. Do you deserve restitution for what the church did to you?
No, I was a kid.
Ooh, good question. Well, so is this. He's
17. I learned something.
More coming up here. 855-450-FREE. You can take control here. The Bible stickers. We got to get back to that. Coming up.
I want to share something important that will not only improve your life, but the lives of many others as well. And all you need to do is drink coffee. I'm not talking about harmful store-bought or chain coffee. No, this is truly the best of the best coffee. We've partnered with Camano Island Coffee Roasters to offer BuzzBox. With every purchase, 10% goes towards our efforts to give the gift of human freedom by providing at least 100 microfinance loans via World Vision. So literally, just one cup at a time, you're having an impact in helping make a difference in the world. And one sip will have you buzzing to family and friends. To prove just how good it is, we're giving a free pound of coffee to everyone in the audience. All you do is cover shipping. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com. BuzzBox Coffee is organic, so it contains no pesticides or toxins. It's shade grown, so less acidity and no heartburn. It's top 1% Arabica grade and gives people the opportunity to own their own coffee farms. Join us in making a huge impact at coffee.freetalklive.com.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938.
I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadadi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. Hey! That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com. Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you're helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it. Use it. Spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial in toll-free here and bring up anything on your mind at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Go to freetalklive.com. Get interactive there. We like Bitcoin here on Free Talk Live, and you can go and get Bitcoin easily by going to expresscoin.com. Now, you do have to have a Bitcoin wallet set up first, so if you haven't done that step yet, go to blockchain.info or blockchain.com, rather, is probably an easier way to get the wallet. Blockchain.com, get your Bitcoin wallet set up. Then, once you're ready to load it up, go to expresscoin.com. And let's just say you're not quite sure about jumping into the deep end on this Bitcoin thing, but you got a few bucks you're willing to spend. If you spend less than $40 and you use our code FTL, like Free Talk Live, at expresscoin.com, you'll get that $40 worth of Bitcoin, or rather up to $40 worth of Bitcoin. You'll get it at cost. There's no transfer fee. You will literally pay 0% to transfer your cash into Bitcoins over at expresscoin.com. That's, again, code FTL. Now, if you buy more than $40 worth, no reason to put the code in. I mean, it wouldn't hurt, but you're not going to get them for free. You'll get them for 3%, which is the best price I think you're going to be able to find. Especially for the level of service you're getting from expresscoin.com, because they are really concerned with making sure you are happy, and obviously they're interested in doing business with you again in the future. So go to expresscoin.com. You can not only get Bitcoin from them, you can also get Dogecoin, Litecoin, Blackcoin, and Darkcoin. Plus, you can do it from Canada. You can do it from your smartphone as well by downloading their app. Get started at expresscoin.com. As we continue, your calls and thoughts are welcome. Let's go to Steve in West Virginia, listening to Charleston's WVTS. Hello, Steve.
Hey, how you doing?
Great. Go ahead.
Thank you for accepting my call, man.
That's what we do. Go ahead, Steve.
Oh, yeah. I don't think we should send any money to...
Steve?
I don't see why we got to send money to the ISIS or the Kurds or whatever. I don't think we should do that.
Mm-hmm.
And... we should just send troops, I mean, a bunch of them.
So what would you like to see? How many troops?
Probably like 40,000.
What do you want to see them do? What would the troops' job be?
To kill.
Of course.
But who and where do they stop? Do they just
run them all?
Do they run up to the border of Syria and stop there?
No, they should help Israel too on their side.
Oh, I mean, Israel doesn't need your help, son. Israel is doing just fine.
How they
got F-16s. They got that Iron Dome. They don't need that help.
A lot of that money came from the American government, right?
Most of it's military aid.
How many, Steve? I mean, how many more lives must be ended? How much more blood must be shed before finally whatever it is happens that you're looking for will happen? What is it you're looking for, by the way? What's the end game here?
How many people do you have to kill to get peace?
A bunch.
Brother, are you for real?
Like at least 30,000.
Is this a crank call, or do you really believe what you're saying to us tonight?
I believe what I'm serious.
Please explain to me, how can you get to peace by having violence as your means?
What else can we do? There's nothing else we can do.
How about you go home and have the military guys get the hell out of there?
Let's learn a lesson from history here, shall we? The United States has got involved in Iran, installed a Shah. That backfired. We had the attack of the students in 1970 that wiped out those Americans, and they were held hostage for that length of time. The United States was involved with the Iraq war against Iran. Then Saddam Hussein turned on us. We killed him. Then the United States was involved with, on the side of – was for Gaddafi, against Gaddafi, then supporting al-Qaeda in Libya, then supporting al-Qaeda in Syria against Assad. Now they're going to want to support Assad against al-Qaeda. Maybe we're the problem, not the solution.
You mean the U.S. government? Because I'm not doing that stuff.
I think he probably identifies with the U.S. government, though.
Okay, well, then don't say we unless are including you, Mark. Go ahead, Steve.
Yeah, I think we should do something. Get other countries involved. I mean,
did you hear anything that Mark just said? Do you have any specific response to the words that just came out of Mark's mouth about the U.S. military and CIA, etc., interventionism over in other countries being the cause of the issues?
Oh, shoot. I didn't realize that. So they are stirring up some junk.
I don't know how we can communicate, Steve, but I thank you for the call tonight. I appreciate it. I tried. I really tried. I know I can only try so long before people start tuning out. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. It's Blowback. I mean, this is, I don't know who wrote the book, but Ron Paul was promoting it at one time. There's a book called Blowback. If you want to read it, that'll tell you all about it.
It's a pretty simple concept.
Actions equal reactions equals reactions equals reactions.
A country that fought a revolutionary war against a king should not be supporting kings and dictators around the world. And when you do, there are going to be consequences. Those people in those countries want self-actualization. For some of them, that means an Islamic caliphate. For others of them, it means a democratic government. But you don't get to decide.
Hash it out.
The United States has done decades of supporting dictators and kings. Mm. You see what happened in Egypt?
Where's the peace, right? Yep. Is the purported reason for having these alliances to supposedly create peace? Because it hasn't worked. Maybe the idea of removing the troops from the, 1,000 now military bases? I've heard, years ago we were saying 700. Is it 1,000 now? I don't know.
It depends hundreds. On what you call a base. They have these things called forward bases, which are just camps. It just really depends.
Well, whatever. Remove them all and bring them back to the United States and then tell them to go get real jobs that can actually help the economy rather than blowing stuff up all around the world and ending innocent life. Because violence just begets violence. If you go over there and start shooting people or turning places into glass, then don't be surprised when the same stuff comes back here. And in fact, I'm surprised more of it hasn't. I really am surprised at that. I don't want to see that happen. But considering all of the killing and all of the destruction that has happened in the Middle East, the idea that the United States has only lost a couple of towers and a few plane, you know, a couple other planes.
There have been a few things since then too. There was the Boston Marathon,
the Boston thing. Okay.
There was the guy with the Explorer truck in Times Square.
Yep, he got foiled.
Yeah, foiled by citizens, not by FBI. The FBI has managed to dupe a bunch of people.
About the summary though, Mark. Over that's about 14 it. Years now or 13 years.
There was the psychologist that the Fort Hood
shooter
right. there
who shot at a bunch of unarmed people military base.
I don't know what to say about the United States military disarming its soldiers stateside. I don't have a statement for that.
Yeah. All right. Let's continue here. We've got Nathan. He's in Texas on Skype. Go ahead, Nathan.
Well, it makes perfect sense, Mark, because So anyway, I want to thank the previous caller who talked about the tattooing, because I was actually in a tattoo parlor earlier today.
Uh-huh.
And thank goodness that I learned that it was against the word.
The word of Jesus, you mean?
Actually, it's in the Old Testament.
Oh, so it's the word of God.
And I found out what the Quran says as well.
Okay, now look, when we brought this up earlier, I kind of questioned it. I thought it was the whole your body is a temple thing, but Mark, you said there's a different explanation.
Leviticus 19.
And you never really gave what that explanation was. So
it's
maybe
a Bible verse.
Well, maybe you could tell me more about what it says here in a moment, and we'll hear from Nathan as well with the Muslim side of things. It's Free Talk Live.
Dr. Wallach, an award-winning scientist, naturopathic physician, author of several books such as Dead Doctors Don't Lie, Let's Play Doctor, and a Nobel Prize nominee. Dr. Wallach will be here on September 15th and 16th. Wallach has proven that diseases classified as autoimmune were in fact caused by nutritional deficiencies. Get your free ticket to hear about the true causes of diseases. Call 763-291-5052. To receive your free ticket, call 763-291-5052.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
George, you can go this way.
You can do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring signs into the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who
do you think you
are? Excuse me.
There is no video or audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make it.
Wait,
you gotta come.
Now. Wait a minute.
Really,
whoa.
Hey!
God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you're scared of me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, here to take your calls about anything via the toll-free number brought to you by ProXPN. That number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Earlier, Johnson asked a question about stickers that you could put on the front of a Bible that you might find in a hotel room. We never really finished up that conversation. I did have something to say about it, and you may have something to say as well. We would love to hear from you at 855-450-FREE.
So there's a Bitcoin party going on at the Walt Disney World Resort in Orlando, Florida. It's called Coins in the Kingdom. Free Talk Live is going to be there, and you're invited. There's going to be lots of speakers like Jeffrey Tucker from Liberty.me. I just spoke with him today. The creators of Skyhook, MIT Bitcoin Project, Cryptocurrency College Network, Digital Chamber of Commerce, Bitcoin Not Bombs, Mycelium. It's going to be a great time at the Wyndham Lake Buena Vista in downtown Disney, Saturday, the October the 4th to Monday, October the 6th. Tickets are only $60 for the event. Hotel rooms, $99. Kids under 12 are free. Fun is mandatory. Come celebrate magic internet money at the Magic Kingdom. Coinsinthekingdom.com. It's going to be a lot of fun. Coinsinthekingdom.com.
All right, let's continue here. We have Nathan on the line. He was talking about tattoos. There was a statement made earlier about what the Bible apparently says about tattoos. I had thought that the prohibition was on doing something bad to your temple, but as though your body is a temple, right? You're not supposed to put bad things in it, was what I had understood about it. But Mark, you said there's a more specific issue with Leviticus or something like
Leviticus
that.
Leviticus 19:28. You got a favorite version?
No, I don't read the Bible.
Okay. I'm fond of the New International Version. Do not cut your bodies for the dead or put tattoo marks on yourself. I am the Lord. It ends up, by the way, a lot with that. Like, you know, I am the Lord.
It's sort of like it's the law, right? That's like the new version of that.
Sure.
Buckle up. It's the law. Buckle up. I am the Lord.
So, you're not supposed to tattoo yourself. You're not supposed to make marks in remembrance of the dead. Hmm. And this was a relatively common practice, still common today. You'll see people walking around with in memory of
R.I.P.
Yeah, sure. Things like that. You know. So there you go.
All right. So
every
time
I hear the Lord recently, I don't know why I've been just thinking about this, because you guys probably were a couple of days ago having a conversation about the word liege.
Yes.
Yeah. And so I've been thinking about it. And every time I hear like the Lord or people, you know, things being referred to as Lord or liege, I think of landlords.
Yes.
And so like when you're talking about this, I like think like, thou shalt not paint the walls. Thou shalt not have a pet without written consent. You know, that's just like.
So what was the thrust of your tattoo related call here tonight, Nathan?
Oh, well, that's a good one. I am the landlord, right? So it was interesting because I was curious what the Quran says about tattooing, and maybe it might be a little more permissive than the Torah. And in fact, it is, because the Quran doesn't actually say anything about tattoos.
Interesting.
But, and here's the catch, in Islam, there is also the Hadith, which are sayings and teachings about the life of Muhammad.
Yes.
And the most reliable of these was assembled about 200 years after Muhammad died by a man named Sahih al-Bukhari. And he says that women who practiced tattooing, and as well as those who removed hair from their faces and those who created spaces between their teeth artificially to look beautiful, I'm not sure what that means, those ladies are cursed. And there's actually a dialogue, which I think is very instructive. Right afterward, a woman questions Abdullah and says, well, you know, why are you saying this? And she says, by Allah, I have read the whole Quran, but I have not found such a thing. And the holy man, Abdullah, replies, by Allah, if you had read it carefully, you would have found it where it says, and what the apostle gives you, take it, and what he forbids you, abstain it.
So he's claiming to be an apostle, and so therefore anything he says goes? is the idea.
Basically.
Yeah.
And that's the interesting thing about it is that that's actually true in pretty much, I mean, almost all religions I can think of. There might be exceptions, but there's always a cast.
They're always very malleable to some extent.
Yeah. There's always a priest, some kind of holy person who interposes between you and the divine figure.
Sure, that is the nature of an organized religion, is that there is somebody, in most cases, with the exception of the Quakers, and maybe a few others.
But the Quakers are barely, you could barely even call them organized. They certainly have
been. They sit in a circle, and that's organization.
But this is really the catch all along, is that this is religion. This is the problem I have with religion, is it's somebody says, hey, God's a-talking to me. You better listen, right? And then I'll tell you what God says. You'll be just fine. You listen to me. And that's a terrible thing. If you're listening to that, you're being fooled. If, in my opinion, if God speaks, he speaks to you about things that are relevant to you.
Yeah, directly.
And that's, anything other than that is just somebody yickety-yacking about the crap they believe.
Good call tonight, Nathan. Thanks for it. Toll-free number 855.
That's why I don't accept the Bible as the Word of God, because that's God talking to somebody else.
It's an interpretation. 855-450-FREE. And that's true of all of the religious books out there. You know, somebody wrote those, not God, and it was their best understanding of what they thought God was at that point in time. And that understanding should change over time as we learn more about our universe and as we learn more about ourselves. But I also agree that that's why I was saying before, I have a lot more respect for people who seek religion for their own personal reasons rather than going to some sort of organized religion where they're told how things are. I like the idea of somebody seeking on their own and making their own decisions about
That is not to say that I don't think that one can read religious texts, ancient texts, and find God speaking to them through it. I just don't think that we should take the word of a bunch of Bronze Age tent dwellers and as, you know, somehow the end all be all of God's vision.
I like the idea that God is speaking to you in a lot of different ways. Whether or not you're aware of it or open to it is another question, but, you know, I see it in song lyrics and I see it in a lot of different places.
I think what God really is just a pattern recognition error in the human brain, which is what studies have shown.
Fine by me. I'll take it.
It's just people that just spot patterns. When it's like, it's a bunny in the clouds.
Well,
therefore, that must be God.
I can't entirely disagree with what you say. However, that doesn't resonate with me, right? Like, I searched and searched for years. The conclusion I came to was, I believe there's a God. And, like, that's the truth for me. Yeah. I get that it may not be the truth for other people, and I will not vilify them, I will not jeer at them, and I will not refuse to vote for them simply because they're atheists. I just, hey, you know, you and I don't agree on that.
I have a lot of respect for atheists. I was one for a good solid decade to 13 or so years of my life. And then I discovered the ideas of panentheism, which I happen to like better. They make more sense to me. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Greg, with us in Brooklyn. You're on Free Talk Live. Greg.
Hey, guys.
Hi, Greg. You're on the air. Did we just lose Greg? Oh, that was unfortunate. Greg, I'm going to put you back on hold here, and we will come back to you. So we were talking about these Bible stickers. Johnson, there is a warning sticker that talks about all the, you know, the terrible stuff that happens in the Bible, murders, incests, rape, etc.
Right.
And then, you know, it also recommends that, you know, you be very cautious if you're going to pick this thing up and read it. That's in a short version. You read the whole thing earlier. The idea is to take these stickers in and lay them on top of the Gideon Bible. So attach it to a Bible that would be like in a hotel room or something.
Yeah. I mean, that's one idea. I mean, one of the other more despicable versions of that would be to go into bookstores and label the books in the bookstore.
That would be illegal. But the question I think you were asking earlier was specifically about the Gideon Bibles in hotel rooms. And that would be, is it a property rights violation to put a sticker on the Gideon Bible, being that, with the idea at least being that the Gideons have donated the Bible, and you said you heard, Johnson, that the hotels are okay with people taking those Bibles?
Yeah,
is that
true?
Yeah. That's really the way out on this one, is that these Bibles aren't
fixtures. They're not owned.
They're not fixtures of the room.
Right, unlike taking
the chair.
A towel or a light bulb.
Right, these are donations to anybody who wishes to take them out of the hotel room. I'm sure you could go to the front of the hotel and say, hey, I'm down on my luck. Can I have a Gideon's Bible? And they would give it to you because they've got boxes of these things that Gideon donates to them. So they're, you know, I mean, this noose has slipped at this point. Yes, you're allowed to stick a sticker on your Bible. And yes, you're allowed to leave it wherever you want.
I think it's pretty, it's an interesting idea.
I think that it's a better question is, why is there a difference between somebody rearranging reindeers in lewd fashions and somebody humping magic rocks in the front of churches? I think that's a better question.
Why is there a difference? I don't understand your question, so you have to rephrase it here in moments. 855-450-FREE, you take control. Free Talk Live.
Wake up and smell the freedom. One of the easiest things you can do to help Liberty is to torrent Freedom Fiends episodes to help keep them drone-proof. You can set up your home computer to download and share Freedom Fiends archives over BitTorrent. You can even set up scheduling so it only shares while you're asleep or at work. Put your unused computing power to work and help keep the Freedom Fiends around well into the future. Simply go to freedomfiends.com and click on the Torrent Club link and learn how to torrent and share Freedom Fiends archives.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
If you need to say happy birthday, happy anniversary, thank you, or simply, I'm thinking of you, ProFlowers.com is the key. ProFlowers has stunning bouquets, like the best-selling 100 blooms for $19.99. Plus, ProFlowers will include a glass vase for free. Sending someone a wonderful surprise of beautiful flowers sent fresh from the fields is easy. Choose the bouquet you like, pick the delivery date, and each order is 100% guaranteed. Plus, all bouquets from ProFlowers are guaranteed to last at least 7 full days. Beautiful, fragrant flowers, picked fresh and sent to your loved one for lasting enjoyment. To get this incredible savings and send someone 100 gorgeous blooms with a free vase for $19.99, go to ProFlowers.com, click the blue microphone in the top right corner, and enter code PLOW. That's ProFlowers.com. Click the mic and enter code PLOW.
If you're looking for work, the person you are applying to may be even more nervous than you are. And the way things are now, your references have never been more important. Here are three tips. First, know that employers are checking. Every hire is under the microscope these days. Second, they won't just be checking references you provide. Figure that all of your ex-employers will get a call and be asked, would you hire him or her again? Third, assume you will be Googled. So before you apply, remove all those party animal photos from your Facebook page. Even if you're not in the job market, effective communication skills have never been more important, with money and attention so scarce now. For more tips for job seekers and getting better results in all your day-to-day communication, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket, shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. Just moments remain here, but there's plenty of time for you. If you want to dial in toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Go to freetalklive.com. Get interactive and enjoy the features there. If you like the show and you want to help support Free Talk Live, then shop with us. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and you can enter Amazon through the links you'll find there. Amazon UK, Amazon Canada, as well as Amazon US. You just click into the right Amazon for you, get your shopping taken care of, and Free Talk Live gets a cut. It is that simple. Shop.freetalklive.com. Now, I apologize. There was some sort of technical difficulty. Apologize to our radio listeners. Internet listeners, you had no idea. But radio listeners, we dropped out in the last segment for like 30 seconds. There was some sort of internet.
Something bad happened.
Some kind of internet thing happened here, and it was a problem. So we actually had Greg on the line. He was probably trying to say hello to us when I took his call earlier, yeah. And we could not hear you, even though you were there. Go ahead, Greg.
Yeah, hey, guys. No, first of all, some interesting conversations today. I like how you guys end with encouraging people to think for themselves. I think that's really important. So basically, I wanted to keep with my theme of just talking about, you know, rights and statism and all that. And I kind of just want to talk about rights as protections, protections from the government. So basically, I also care about actual freedom and prosperity for people. I just don't think that the philosophical freedom that maybe anarcho-capitalists proposed everybody would have is actual freedom. Because if I look at a guy, you know, who's like elderly and he's out of work and, you know, his job has been eliminated and he doesn't have enough will to get back in the game, I think he's not free in the sense that market discipline makes him have to do things that he otherwise wouldn't do. And so if we can increase actual freedom, I would be happier than if we would have liberty in the sense of like property rights or something like that. That's why I'm not too, you know, too upset.
Now, tell me more about what actual freedom would mean. What would the ideal freedom for this man be?
Well,
freedom from responsibility?
I think at a minimum, if there would be, like I said, wealth redistribution to the point where this person could survive, could have a, you know, a minimal existence where
so
they could,
in that world, just curious, in the world with the wealth redistribution that you're thinking of, in that, in theory, everyone could just survive then, right? Like, that would be the idea. Like, if I didn't want to work, I could just get the survival check, right?
Of course, that would be real freedom.
Cool. So yeah. what if like most people decided they wanted the survival check? Rather than, well, I mean, because work sucks. I'd like to just say, going to a job for a lot of people in this world is not a pleasant experience. Now, they do it because they know it's a way to, you know, get some money and so they can have things they enjoy, etc. And I imagine what you would suggest would be that the survival check probably wouldn't pay as well as maybe actually doing something productive in your ideal world. Would that be true?
Exactly.
Okay.
And what you're
but a lot of people are okay with just surviving. A lot of people are okay with it because while they're surviving, they can also be doing things like selling drugs and selling sex on the side so they can supplement their incomes.
Work under the table in other ways.
Yeah, work under the table, get the survival check in, cash that, and then make some more money in Bitcoin or whatever.
Yeah, that's really the problem with I have with this, Greg, is that we pulled ourselves up out of the one-celled world by the need to survive. And what you're doing is you're taking away people's need to survive. You're saying to the human species, everything's fine. You've done okay now. You could just relax.
That sounds great to me. I would love to just sit back and get high and play video games all day long. And that's what you would be allowing me to do, right? Just because I was born and, you know, I exist. I deserve that.
Well, I mean, I think I'm playing the freedom card here. I'm saying you guys are basically arguing to force people to work, to create conditions where you're saying it's
not at all. No one's forcing anyone to work. You could always go out and live in the woods and then, you know, live off the land. That wouldn't be a problem. You have that freedom.
Right, exactly. Exactly. And I'm saying you're basically admitting that if they had the freedom, many of them would choose not to work.
I would not. Liberty is different than freedom. So liberty doesn't mean freedom from consequences. You have the consequences of your actions, which is to say that, you know, if you choose not to work, you will not get anything for free. Where do you think these working people are going to come from? Don't you think that you're just going to stifle innovation everywhere?
I think the current system is actually perverse. I'll explain. For example, just let me explain this. Right now, And I'm talking about right now, in the America that we live today. A friend of mine, his daughter works in a pharmacy. She has to work 10 hours a day, 11 hours, with no overtime pay because she's afraid to lose her job. Meanwhile, another person trying to get that same job is denied. The company doesn't want to hire them. So if you remove the money aspect, look how perverse it is. Those two people could have had normal hours, could have gone home and done better work. But because that they don't have that safety net, it's perverse. So it's actually worse and it's less efficient without the safety net right now. And it's less free.
So your claim is, let's just make sure I understood what you just said. Your claim is that the person working in the pharmacy that you're talking about, if they knew they had this subsistence check available to them, that they could just walk away from a job they didn't like for as long as they felt they needed to, and then they could get another job whenever they felt like they wanted, right?
It would empower the people. That subsistence check would be unconditional whether you worked
unconditional,
or not.
So they
would,
right. Right. So how? I'm just curious. Out of 100, let's just say, out of 100 people in this theoretical world of yours, out of 100 of them, how many of them would accept the subsistence check, and how many of them would seek for seek work?
Well, it's not an either or. They get the subsistence check no matter what. So what I'm
saying
is,
oh, I see what you're saying.
But don't you think that if a majority of people got this subsistence check and liked it, then shouldn't they demand a higher rate over time? I mean, wouldn't they be able to say, look? You know, I was getting $100, but $100 isn't quite enough. I can only afford a regular phone, not a smartphone, and I've got a human right to a smartphone. So then they'd be just continually voting themselves more stuff. And the people, at some point, the guy at the top says, you know what? Screw this. I'm going to take my money, and I'm going to stop providing jobs.
Hold on a second. This is why I say a minimum subsistence check. But then what you would see, and this is very crucial, you wouldn't see the 99% against the 1%. Saying that, oh, we don't have any power. Because what would happen is the people would say, instead of saying, oh, sir, can I work for you 10 hours, 11 hours, sir, just don't fire me, they would say, what's in it for me? Why should I work for you 10 hours when I can work for you 6 hours? I'd rather have a part-time job and do something else with my life that's more productive, like with my family, for example.
You can already negotiate with employers to get the hours that you want.
I've got to say that you know, the idea of an employee working part-time is less valuable to me than an employee working full-time. I want somebody dedicated to the job.
And what about the business owners? Realize, I mean, they're getting screwed in this deal, right?
No, it's not the business owners that are getting screwed. The business owners could hire the two people, right? They could hire that person who they don't want to hire.
No, they couldn't. Those two people could do whatever they wanted. What you're doing is you're creating a world where everybody says, if I don't get to do the job that I love, I'll just not work. And they'll never work themselves up. I've got a job that many people would love to have. But I wash dishes. I put roofs on houses. I worked at a convenience store. I waited tables.
You went to prison.
Well, I mean, all these things, that wasn't really part of it. But, I mean, I worked my butt off to get to the point where I was, and I got lucky because I showed up every day.
Greg, thanks for the call tonight. Let's go to Jonathan in West Virginia. You're on Free Talk Live. Jonathan.
Hi, guys. Just with the topic that was just brought up with the socialist sort of mindset of redistributing wealth and the idea that it works out. And it's funny because the Romans tried it in ancient Rome of just giving out food to those that had need. And so the initial result was that the farmers quit growing food because nobody was buying for it because the government was just distributing it for free.
Right. What's their incentive? I mean, the argument would be that their incentive would be for the betterment of mankind. But if you're out there busting your back in the fields, pulling corn or whatever it is you're pulling, and, you know, you're spending hours per day doing that work, and then everybody's just sitting around collecting a check, and they're not doing that kind of, they're not doing that level of work, that's going to really grind at you at some point, and you're going to say, screw this.
Oh, absolutely. And the problem with it, even just, and you know, some of these people are sincere because they honestly believe.
Oh,
but
yeah.
The problem, and those people who actually hold to the socialist mindset, is they judge based upon sort of reflecting, well, they think that they would do those things. And so they believe that obviously everybody else would do it. And so they sort of project their own morality upon everybody else.
Yeah, that's true.
And so at the end of it, it's just you're presupposing before anything that the morality level is the same amongst every single individual in the entire group.
Good point.
Right. I had a situation at one point where I was taken care of. Mm-hmm. I had enough money to
Sugar Mama?
I had my mama, essentially. I had a situation where I didn't have to work very hard. You know, everything wasn't perfect by any means, but I didn't have to work if I didn't want to. I just, you know, got up whenever I want, went to sleep whenever I want, drank whatever I want. Pretty soon I'm ready to put a bullet in my head. I mean, seriously, the only time I ever considered,
suicide.
The only time I considered suicide for a moment was when I didn't have a job.
Wow. Hey, thanks, Jonathan, for the call. We're out of time for tonight, but we'll be back tomorrow. You can join us online in the meantime at freetalklive.com. We will see you there.
Free Talk Live.
Crack cocaine, the way it hurts individuals and communities, I would really like to see dealers get the death penalty.
Why are you so violent?
It's a violent drug. It gets to your brain. It reorganizes. It actually physically changes the structure of your brain.
Yeah, that's true with alcohol. The community is being put in danger by the fact that these drugs are illegal. I don't use crystal meth, but I'm in danger from those who do use crystal meth in that if they need another hit and they can't afford it and their drug dealer's not willing to accept a BJ in order to give them a hit of crystal meth, then they are going to go and steal things, break into cars, break into homes. If you can't see how prohibition creates more problems than it solves, if you can't see how prohibition leads to more violence,
just look at Al Capone and the history of alcohol. Yes. It's simple.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Thursday, September 11th, 2014. Gold opened today at $1,243, silver opened at $18.75, and Bitcoin is trading around $473.69. Support for Liberty Beat comes from SovereignMiners.com. Interested in mining Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies? Sovereign Miners has you covered. All purchases come with a free Script ASIC miner. Visit SovereignMiners.com to buy your miner today. And support comes from the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. Vote Michael Cargill to get the cars moving. Learn more or sign up to volunteer at CargillForTexas.com. Political advertisement paid for by the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. On the eve of the 13th anniversary of the 9/11 attacks, President Obama announced his plan to degrade and ultimately destroy the Islamic State. The president said the plan will include continued airstrikes, counterterrorism actions, support from allied nations, and military training and assistance for rebels in Iraq and Syria. Obama asked for support from the House and the Senate to show the world the U.S. was united against ISIS. Protesters with the Justice for Michael Brown Leadership Coalition temporarily blocked Interstate 70 near Ferguson, Missouri, on the one-month anniversary of Michael Brown's death. The act of civil disobedience was done to ensure Ferguson is not forgotten, the organizers said. Several arrests were made as a heavy police presence arrived. Authorities brought out the LRAD sound cannon for what they say was a safety precaution. The civil disobedience followed a busy city council meeting on Tuesday night, where hundreds of outraged Ferguson residents expressed their anger. Several changes were announced by the city council, including plans to create a citizens' review board for the police department. The 8th Annual Farm and Food Leadership Conference will take place Monday, September 15th, and Tuesday, September 16th, in Bastrop, Texas. Catch up on the latest legislative and regulatory news regarding our food supply and leave with the tools needed to make a difference. The keynote speaker will be Jim Hightower, national radio commentator, writer, public speaker, and author of the book Swim Against the Current. Even a dead fish can go with the flow. Lunch will be provided both days from local foods prepared by Chef Sonia Cote of Hillside Pharmacy in Eden East. For more info, including a full list of conference topics and speakers, visit farmandranchfreedom.org. Support for Liberty Beat comes from My Magic Mud, all natural teeth whitener. Go to MyMagicMud.com to hear a short interview with Dr. Griffin Cole. That's MyMagicMud.com. And today's edition of the Liberty Beat is brought to you by Brave New Books, your source for all things Bitcoin. Now hosting a Bitcoin ATM, located in Austin, Texas at 1904 Guadalupe Street, or online at BraveNewBookstore.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, September 11, 2014. Check out the website at TheLibertyBeat.com and like us on Facebook at Facebook.com/TheLibertyBeat. A Pennsylvania teenager is facing criminal charges after posting pictures to Facebook of him simulating a sex act with a statue of Jesus. KRON 4 News reports the teen posted that he took the pictures in late July at the statue of a kneeling Jesus in front of the Love in the Name of Christ Christian organization in his hometown of Everett. The criminal charge, which will be heard in family court, consists of desecration of a venerated object. Pennsylvania law defines desecration as defacing, damaging, polluting, or otherwise physically mistreating in a way that the actor knows will outrage the sensibilities of persons likely to observe or discover the action. The teen, whose name has not been released, could face up to 2 years in a juvenile jail if convicted. An international human rights group says Israel committed war crimes in the latest round of fighting against Hamas in Gaza. The Associated Press reports that New York-based Human Rights Watch made the conclusion following an investigation it carried out into attacks on or near three UN-run schools housing displaced Palestinians. The group said Thursday that no military targets were apparent in the school area and that some of the attacks were indiscriminate. The Israeli military had no immediate comment. On Wednesday, it announced it launched its own probe into the war. Israel accuses Hamas of using civilians as human shields. A plan is underway by Ecuadorian President Rafael Correa to begin taxing fast food restaurants and using the funds for health awareness campaigns. The so-called junk food tax would focus on international fast food chains, but did not specify when the tax might begin. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries, homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. And support comes from Roberts & Roberts Brokers Incorporated, specializing in precious metals since 1977. Now accepting Bitcoin, online, rrbi.co, or by phone, 800-874-9760. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, September 11th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting.
Amid the catastrophic economic crisis spurred by Tuesday's release of This Christmas, the new holiday-themed album by John Travolta and Olivia Newton-John, economic experts told reporters today the Christmas CD has quickly plunged the nation into a double-dip recession.
When investors learned that one-time screen couple John Travolta and Olivia Newton-John had reunited after 35 years for an album of timeless Christmas classics, investors had no choice but to pull money from markets immediately. We were already on shaky ground with the collapse of the U.S. subprime mortgage market and the reversal financial crisis in Europe, but consumer confidence plummeted after Americans saw the new album with a picture of Travolta and Olivia Newton-John holding cups of hot cocoa. We believe that when other countries find out the album features a Christmas song that pays tribute to summer nights, we could be looking at a global contagion. This is the blackest day on Wall Street in two decades.
This is the Onion News Network.
It's time for Off the Air Live. And here's your host, Cody O'Connor.
All right, so today is Thursday. It is also September of the 11th. Oh, there was something that we were supposed to never do. What the hell was it? I forget. Well, anyways, it's going to be a fantastic episode of Off the Air Live tonight. Thursday edition of the show, top of the hour to you. Furthermore, lines are open at 774-314-7067, or you can Skype in at Off the Air Live. All kinds of stuff we can talk about. that has happened since the last time we've communicated, the last time we had a transmission, as Alex Jones likes to put it. You can't just call it a radio show. You can't just call it a broadcast. No, it's a transmission. Because it sounds way more epic when you call it that. Because everybody's got a radio show or a podcast. But how many people have a transmission? You know, it's almost like he's trying to be the type of person that you wouldn't trust. Well, where's this weird signal coming from? What? A strange white dude with long, weird yellow hair from a trailer out in the middle of fucking Boise, Idaho or something? Yeah, well, maybe I would not exactly trust his sources first. You know, but I don't want to make fun of those people on a day like today. Because I feel like those people on a day like today are getting enough of that. I may be one of those people today. You know, my friend this morning, Mike, he messaged me right in the morning. He said, "Hey, man, happy 9/11, bro." And I said, "More like happy Cody bites his tongue day," or "happy I stay off from Facebook for my own good day." I mean, that's what it really boils down to. Because, you know, you're always going to get those people, the never forgetters. I think that's what I'm going to start calling them. I mean, there's only 2 more hours left of today, so we're not going to have enough time to make that trending. But these goddamn never forgetters, they'll never let you forget. That's the thing. That's the thing that's so annoying. And, if this is the first time you've heard this show, you're probably very offended by me even saying something like that. What? You can't be annoyed by people remembering a tragedy. I just did. I went there, okay? I mean, if we want to talk about tragedies, we can talk about tragedies. That's fine. So, okay, so 3,000 people died on September 11th. How many millions of innocent civilians have died in the war on terror that subsequently happened in the aftermath of September 11th? How many hundreds of thousands of just civilian Middle Easterners who, yeah, you're right, they look like them goddamn terrorists, those weaselly little sand niggers, you know, I get it. But maybe they don't deserve to die just because they look a little bit differently. Maybe they prefer the Quran over the Bible. Who cares? They picked a different lie. They picked a different book filled with bullshit. Good for them. All right? 99% of them are not out there blowing people up or shooting anything. And I feel like that needs to be said. It should be an obvious statement, but it needs to be said over and over again because there's this new thing. Well, it's not even a new thing. This is actually a pretty old thing, but it keeps coming up. This thing that the conservatives like to say, which is, well, how come none of these Muslims, these Arabs are apologizing for these Al-Qaeda terrorists, these Talibanis, these ISIS motherfuckers? How come they're... You know, how come moderate Muslims aren't apologizing for that? The same reason why white people aren't apologizing for the KKK. Just because you're of the same group, you know, you were born this way. I mean, honestly, you can almost say that religion in most cases is ingrained into you as much as your race is. There's people who escape from religion and even less people who decide randomly, oh, I feel like converting to Judaism, which is so weird, but people do it. But most people, they're just born as that, and then that's what they are. So they're born as a Muslim, they're born being brown, and that's their color. But the part that they get to decide is whether or not they want to take that to the level of, oh, now we kill people. That's what we do. We kill people now. And most people do not do that. So they don't have to apologize to the ones that are crazy. When you say things like that, you sound racist. And it's always those people who I'm pretty sure are racist are the ones who are always talking about how not racist they are. And you just want to ask them, like, okay, so when was the last time you, like, hung out with a black person and it was not completely out of guilt? You know what I mean? These people are just weird. And that's the stuff that's going to be driving this, whatever is going to be happening in Syria. I guess it's airstrikes. They're playing on your emotions, America. You want to pay attention to that? You want to think about it? You want to... I mean, if somebody's fucking with you, wouldn't you want to know? Wouldn't you want to know? I mean, how obvious is it that Obama gives a speech trying to convince us to go to war with brown people the day before the 13th anniversary of 9/11? So everybody's going to be emotional. They're going to be going back and forth with their coworkers about where were you when it took place? This fucking selfish question. Where were you when other people were having a tragedy? Who fucking cares where you were? You're just a person. That makes no sense. That's the dumbest question ever. It just makes it about you. And it's not about you. Everything isn't about you. Shut the fuck up. So everybody's in this emotionally volatile headspace over these, you know, few days. They've got this misguided patriotism. They don't know what to do with it. They're like, God damn it, people attacked us. They hate freedom. What am I going to do with all this anger? They're going to put it towards patriotism. And they're going to trust the government because the government is what the USA is. Okay, so when people say like, well, I love my country, but I'm not so sure about my government. No, it's all the same thing. There's people and then there's the people who... own all the land, and the people who are the assholes with guns who think they're better than you. That's what America is. I'm sorry. I don't consider myself an American. I consider myself a fucking, I consider myself a consciousness that is within this fucking meat package, basically. You know, that's all it really boils down to. And when you start, you know, sectoring yourself off to being a part of Home Team America, that's when things get a little bit weird. Other people are below you. They're not really human. And that's what they want. Because, see, if you can dehumanize people from an entire, everywhere else in the world, it makes it way easier to convince you to go to war with them and allow them to be killed. And you put up no fight while the actual evil people make a shitload of money from the military-industrial complex and all of the oil reserves that they scoop up in the process. And I guarantee I'm sure that's what this Syria thing's about too. And I don't want to hear about this. We have a real threat to this country. First of all, bring it on. Fine. Blow me up. I'm not afraid of death. All right? I'm not going to give up my freedom just because, well, what if they come and blow me up? And what? I don't have to worry about going to work tomorrow again? Fine. You've alleviated me of all my stresses by ending my life. Big fucking deal. I'm not afraid of it. Until then, can I keep my freedoms, please? Please, can you not molest me at the airports? That's all I ask. More coming
on LRN.fm. We talk a lot about alternative currencies. Did you know that now you can buy gold, silver, and other precious metals with bitcoins? LRN.fm has partnered with Amaji Metals to bring you great prices on beautiful 0.999 fine silver, as well as gold, platinum, and other metals. Check out their selection and pay with bitcoins or Federal Reserve notes at metal.lrn.fm. That's metal.lrn.fm. Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, Rich Paul is our first announced keynote speaker, and more are being announced now at keenvention.info. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. You can pre-order your tickets now for just $60 at keenvention.info, or you can pay with Bitcoin. Visit keenvention.info for more information and to lock in your tickets at the pre-order $60 price for the whole weekend. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
Now that you've found the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM, you may want to help expose others to our great programs. To assist you in doing so, you'll find resources at promote.lrn.fm, including details on how to get a free bumper sticker, quarter-page flyers you can print out and distribute, banners for your website, as well as files that will allow you to make your own custom banners and graphics. Visit promote.lrn.fm and help bring new listeners to the Liberty Radio Network. That's promote.lrn.fm.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
Instead of just listening, you can also watch. See the Liberty Radio Network's Keene, New Hampshire-based live shows via our studio cam at cam.lrn.fm. Plus, you'll still be able to listen to the Liberty Radio Network via the cam feed in high quality 24/7, even when there's no live show being produced in our Keene studio. But wait, there's more. Our chat room is built into the cam page so you can interact with other listeners online. Listen, watch, and chat. All free at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
With job numbers near historic lows, Forbes magazine has released a list of tips for finding a job, all of which involve witnessing an employer murder someone. Forbes says despite the grim economy, employers are still hungry for talented workers who know how important it is to forget about whatever they think they saw or heard.
So me and a couple of friends were out smoking at the viaduct the other day, and we saw this really rich guy in a Mercedes pull up in his car and drop nothing. Now I'm the vice president of international development.
According to Goldman Sachs CEO Lloyd Blankfein, we had a great quarter and hired hundreds of new employees. I haven't done anything wrong, and all my employees will tell you the same thing because that's the deal we had. But the article warns that stumbling onto a coke-fueled CEO strangling a prostitute isn't a foolproof method for finding work, because employers are just as likely to murder you as they are to hire you.
This is the Onion News Network.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Give us a call at 774-314-7067 or Skype Off the Air Live. Here's Cody.
With everything said and done, I know I didn't watch Obama's speech last night. Jesus Christ, I'm sure it was terrible. I'd rather go to some random college graduation and see the valedictorian talk about how, you know, this is going to be how our lives are all changing right now, and things are pretty tough, but we got to look to the future, hope and faith and all. Goodbye. I'd rather listen to that than Obama say anything in some goddamn forsaken speech. I'm all set. I mean, I was thinking about checking it out, and it was one of those things where I put in a little bit of effort, and I didn't figure out what time the thing was going to be, so I was like, fuck it, I'm going to bed, I don't care. Every website I looked at said Obama's going to be speaking at prime time. Now, I don't have cable. I don't know what prime time means. There's a time that's prime? What, it's better than all the other times? It thinks it's such a good time In all of the 24 hours, apparently there's 1 hour that's prime. I guess it's 9 o'clock. I didn't know that. I thought it was 7 o'clock. I'm not staying up that late. I had to work at 4:30 in the morning. I'm all set, Obama. I'm not going to stay up and be more tired just so I can hear you claim that, you know, we're not going to put boots on the ground, even though there's already boots on the ground. More boots are coming on the ground. And by the way, can we stop with the boots on the ground thing in general? You know, I'm tangenting away from the fact that that was a complete lie to get to the point that actually makes me more upset, that I'm tired of hearing the phrase boots on the ground. Can we stop saying that? I don't know when that became a thing, but can we stop with us saying that? Say anything else. Troops being sent to the place. Because that's what's happening. If you were sending boots, that would be one thing. See, we call that capitalism, right? Oh, well, China's importing some boots or, you know, yeah, okay, then you're sending boots. And the shipping is ground because you want to save money. You don't want to do overnight. Okay, so there you go. Boots on the ground. You know? You make an order for boots on eBay. You decide you don't want overnight shipping. You get ground. Boots on the ground. Other than that, it's just a nice way of putting, we're sending people to a country to fucking kill other people because these people have guns. It doesn't sound so violent. Oh, boots on the ground. No, you're sending people to fight. Forget the boots. The boots aren't doing shit. Nobody's fighting a war with boots. Nobody's going up to these Arabs and kicking them in the balls and saying, hi, gotcha. And then going home, you know, job well done. They've got guns. They've got tanks. And besides, does it really matter? See, this is the other thing that really pisses me off is that debate about whether, well, it's okay if there aren't boots on the ground. What is that actually saying? It's kind of like a racist type of thing, kind of like a jingoistic type of thing, because what it's saying is that American lives are worth more than lives of people from other places. So as long as we can fight a war from the skies, drop bombs indiscriminately, not giving a shit who the hell we kill. Civilian, bad guy, they all look the same. Kids, we'll just pretend that they're 18. And that way we can consider them enemy combatants. You know, because once they're old enough, we're just going to go ahead and we're going to just assume that they're the bad guys. Because, you know, it makes the statistics look better on our end. So all this is saying is, well, don't worry, guys. You know, yeah, we're still going to war, but don't worry because the people on our side are going to be fine. All right? The people on Team America, that we're not going to die at all because we're going to have unmanned drones do all of the dirty work. We're going to send robots in to do the murder. That doesn't make it more okay. That doesn't make it more justified. We're only going to have civilian death. We're going to only have deaths on the other team. That makes it okay because, trust, you don't know any of those people. So don't worry about it. They're barely even people anyways, right? I mean, they don't even have that many McDonald's over there. How can you consider them anything worth being alive? Just because they have a heartbeat? Fuck them. They believe in Allah. They can fucking go to hell or whatever the equivalent is and the Quran. That's what it's saying to me. So I had no interest and I still don't have an interest of listening to the speech. I've gotten the highlights from people posting statuses on Facebook and I think that's about all that I really need. That's about it. Somebody posted, apparently, it's not a war. No. It's a counter-terrorism campaign. Yikes. Oh, man, the doublespeak, the Orwellian, you know. You know what I'm talking about. It sounds so much nicer. I mean, that's what everything is. It's all about the language. It's all a big old psyop. I hate using that word because it turns people off, but that's what it is. As long as they've got you psychologically, then they win because they know that there's way more of us than them. And if we decided that, hey, you're bullshitting us, we're not okay with it, then this wouldn't happen. Kind of like a couple years ago when Obama really wanted to, you know, go after Assad. Remember when we were on the side of the people who we hate now? Remember that time? It wasn't too long ago. It was about a year ago, actually. I remember it. And where was I going with that? He was trying to convince us, and nobody bought it. It was a bunch of military people saying, I'm not going to fight on the side of Al-Qaeda. So it didn't work out because they knew that if they actually went ahead with the program, there might have been riots or protests. It might have gotten out of hand. You know, it might have created some kind of domino effect that brought the whole system down. Who knows? But it was a calculated effort. So they waited a year. And they decided, well, you know, let's make this easier on everybody. Let's just change the name of Al-Qaeda to ISIS. You know, we'll make it easier on them. And we're going to change sides now. So now we're against these people. We were for them, but now we're against them. And to make sure nobody catches on to that fact, we're going to change their name. That way it'll be less obvious that we armed these motherfuckers. Okay, so maybe they are a legitimate threat. But my only 2 points to that is, one, it's our fault, and two, it's not our fucking business. So we fucked up, and if something bad happens, then it's our fault still.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Ovaltine. Give your kids the nutrition they need to be their best. Visit us at OvaltineUSA.com. Telling your child about healthy food choices is important, but showing her what to eat goes a lot further. Have her help create the grocery list, then bring her to the store with you. Picking out healthy foods together helps kids get in the habit of thinking about what they're eating every day. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Hey guys, Mark Claire here, lionsofliberty.com, where we strive to advance the ideas of liberty daily. We bring you The Morning Roar! That's right, every Monday to Friday we'll have a brand new edition of The Morning Roar, where we provide a roundup of some news stories that you may not find in the mainstream media or even in your typical social media news feed. We find stories that relate to the ideas of liberty and provide you with our liberty perspective on them. Every Monday, we have our longest-running feature, Mondays with Murray, named after the great libertarian Murray Rothbard, where we'll examine an article or an excerpt from his works and help convey his view, along with our little spin as well. We wrap it all up every Friday with Felony Friday, where our own John Odermatt goes out and takes a look at some sort of felony. There's felonies committed every day, you know, whether it's a felony committed by the police, a politician, or even an average citizen. You can find all of this and so much more over at lionsofliberty.com. Advancing the ideas of liberty daily.
The three most important things you can do for LRN.FM are, 1, let your friends know you're listening to LRN.FM on your social networking profile. 2, buy the things you buy online through shop.LRN.FM. 3, give $5 a month to the AMP program at amp.LRN.FM. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same great prices, and LRN gets a cut. Please do your online shopping at shop.lrn.fm.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Off the Air Live.
Hey, bottom of the hour to you. It is Off the Air Live, Thursday edition of the show. You hear us every Thursday and Saturday night at 10 p.m. on LRN.FM and on TalkSuperStation.com as well. Lines are open at 774-314-7067, or you can Skype in at Off the Air Live if you want to. Here's what I'm looking for. In the first hour for calls, 9/11 horror stories, and not like where, you know, you were at 9/11. I mean, if you were, that's interesting and call in, you know, or maybe you were a jumper and you survived. Now you're listening to this show and you're considering killing yourself anyways. That's interesting. You could call in, but I'm thinking about like horror stories and that like people are talking to you in a very weirdly patriotic way. And you don't know how to go about responding to them. You know, what do? Do you lose a friendship? How far do you want to take it? Because there's a lot of responses that you can give to some kind of question like, well, where are you? And what should America do because of this and that and that? Yeah, everything changed. That's another thing that everybody says now. Because, see, I don't know where it comes from. But it's like whenever something happens and it gets ingrained in us, I don't know where it comes from, but there's like three or four different like archetypal sayings that everybody has for a topic. That's what they've emotionally latched onto. I don't know why, because it's safe, because it's easy, everybody's saying it. But one of those things that everybody says is everything changed after that day. So what does that actually mean? What does it actually mean? Everything changed. The world is a scary place now. It's not like it used to be. It used to be all gumdrops and fairies, you know? You get to just skip around doing what you want without the proper documentation, you know? Didn't work out that way, did it? Because then 9/11 happened. So now what we need is somebody to fucking touch your daughter's behind on their way into the fucking airport. This is the only way because everything changed. So I don't know where these phrases come from. They come from somewhere above us. They trickle down. And then it's just things that people say. It becomes ingrained in our consciousness. And it allows us to continually be okay with all of the bullshit that continually happens over and over and over again. It gets worse and worse and worse. And we're like, yep, okay. It's what I got to do. It's what I got to do to make sure that America's safe. And we don't even know what really happened on that day. That's the most fucked up thing about it. That is the most fucked up thing about it. They won't release pictures showing an actual plane hitting the Pentagon. They won't do it. They show a couple grainy stills that show that prove nothing. Don't even get me started on fucking Shanksville. I mean, what is that? You know, there you can look up pictures of a plane crash and you actually see the plane. Okay, when a plane crashes in a field, it doesn't disappear into smoke. It doesn't jettison off into some other dimension, leaving a black trail. But that's what happened in Shanksville, with random parts skewing like miles and miles in whatever direction. It makes no sense. And the only thing that I'll never forget is the fact that no plane hit Tower 7. And let me tell you, most people don't even know that a third tower fell that day. Now, everybody's got this emotional response to 9/11. They're all so upset. And they don't even know that a third fucking tower fell. And it's so bizarre to me. I mean, we'll start on the first two. If you do some research on some of these structural engineers, they'll tell you that the design of these two towers, they were designed to take the impact of multiple planes without going down. And even if they were to go down, they wouldn't go down in free fall. That's something that happens in a controlled demolition. Now, you could almost argue that point with the first two towers. Well, they were hit with a plane, something about burning jet fuel. Well, the steel melted and, you know, the pancake effect or whatever you think is the truth. Because you read the 9/11 commission report and you believe everything the government tells you. But that doesn't prove jack shit about what happened with Tower 7. Nothing hit it and it just spontaneously falls. How? And furthermore, how come a whole bunch of police officers were given a warning, like a 10-second warning, that they were going to bring the building down? Why is there recorded proof of that being a thing that people said? Seems a little bit weird. Also, how convenient that they found passports of the so-called 9/11 hijackers. You know, the burning jet fuel was hot enough to melt steel, but not hot enough to melt and burn passports that were just so conveniently left on the ground for people to pick up and say, here, look, there they are. So I don't know, I don't go too deep into this stuff, but the government theory is, right, that, 13 hijackers, they did all of this. Most of them were Saudi Arabian. So even if you actually believe that story, they're still bullshit, because why didn't we go to war with Saudi Arabia? We were like, no, fuck that. Iraq and Afghanistan. I think you missed the target. You know, it's funny. If you look at some of the funding, where the funding is coming from for ISIS, you'll actually find that it's also coming from Saudi Arabia. Now, I'm not saying go to war with Saudi Arabia, but it's like, why does the U.S. keep on, like, going to these countries that make no sense when you could almost justify one of them? And when I say almost, I mean almost if you were pro-war and murder and intervention, which I am not. Because, you know, here's the bottom line is that no matter which take you have on 9/11, no matter which take you have on ISIS, at the end of the day, the best course of action, morally and, from a fucking planning type of way, strategically, the best course of action is to stay the fuck out of it. That's the best thing that we can do. Stay the fuck out of it. Because every time we start getting involved in these fucking little things, these ventures, what happens? Innocent people die. Their families get mad. They become radical. They want to hurt us. They want to kill us. Do you blame them? Sometimes you got to put the shoe on the other foot and think about, like, what if some country was invading America and you and your mom was caught in the crossfire? Would you really shrug it off and say that it was collateral damage? Would you really shrug it off and go, whoops, it's the fog of war? No, it's not the fog of war. It's a gas grenade followed by bullets. There is no fog of war. And if it is, it's there purposefully to help you forget the fact that this all boils down to making money. So fuck these people in the government. If you trust them for a second, you are an idiot and an imbecile and not somebody who should be listening to this program.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Did you know you can get news updates about what's happening with the Liberty Radio Network delivered in the way you prefer? You can sign up for our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. Plus, you can stay in the loop by joining our Facebook profile at facebook.lrn.fm or follow us at Twitter at twitter.lrn.fm. It's all free. So sign up now at updates.lrn.fm for news updates delivered to your email box, facebook.lrn.fm to follow our Facebook page, and twitter.lrn.fm to receive our tweets.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.